Hello. Good evening. Hello, hello, hello. How's everybody feeling tonight? Hello, David Kendrick, Steven, Betty, Crypto Kid, Bald Shit, CNJ Dev, Lauren's Dirty Shoes, K-Bone, That's Thing One, Robert, Jade, Scott, Pam, Witchert, Jokeder, David Gaffney, Bella G, hello, hello, Leo, Callie Slimebucket, Witch Lady, Winnie's boyfriend slash husband, hello. Rosemary Geyser, generic white female, edamame, Lauren's liver. How's everybody feeling? Anthony Penny, what's good with it? What's good with it? Peter O'Keefe, Julia, Robert Pinex, Mary Mandolin, hello. Custard Gannett, C. Moggle. Anyway, I'll say hello to you guys throughout the night. Anyway, I wanted to do like a more like low-key kind of hangout stream where I just kind of play a game that makes me really angry while we listen to Lauren get really angry. Maybe have some people on to hang out too. I've opened up the... There is a voice channel in the Baked Salmon Discord. This might be a good time to plug Baked Salmon's Patreon. If you donate at least a dollar to Baked Salmon's Patreon, you get access to his Discord server. And there's, you know, a bunch of voice channels. People always hanging out in there. It's great. It's always a party. I always love it. And there is a channel like specifically for going live on air. So I've kind of opened that up. Anybody on the Baked Salmon Discord channel wanted to come on there and like listen to the calls with me, I'm streaming my VLC to that channel also. So you can listen to the calls with me and talk and do whatever. If anybody wants, and also if anybody has like a game they want to play with me, a suggestion, I would totally get a, you know, multiplayer game to play with one of you guys. Anyway. I know, right? Guy named Kevin. And hello, guy named Kevin. I would play Cyberpunk, but I think it would make my computer explode, so I don't think I will. Esp Oreo. The Crucifixion. Oh, man. That's a good one. Okay, yeah, let's get into it. I'm gonna start playing this game. It's called Noita. It pisses me off to no fucking end. It's like, you know, you're a little wizard, you're running around with a little wand shooting spells, and you can throw potions at stuff. But I guess the gimmick on this game is, like, every pixel is simulated, so it's like, you know, if I touch fire, I'll burst into flames unless I jump into water. And there's, like, a lot of different elements at play that will kill me very quickly, and you'll see me get pretty angry at this if, you know, all goes according to plan. So let's also start up a Lorne call. I want to play Dan's Lorne's Boo. The last time I played that was on the Hey Boo, like, stream, like the Dragon Ball Z themed one. That was like 6 months ago, so now's a good time to play it again. And I want to hear it. So, this one's called Dan's Lorne's Boo. And he's pissed, like, right away. So, you already know.
So, are you done having phone sex?
We're not even on the phone. My sister came home.
Yeah, well, you fucking were before!
No, we weren't.
Oh, fucking lie to me!
We weren't,
Fuck off.
You two, I fucking hung up on you two.
Oh my god.
You two were on the fucking phone with each other. Yeah. I called you both back two times each. So you were phone fucking.
Of course.
Don't fucking tell me you weren't. You want to fucking press your goddamn bullshit with fucking Dan. Look at where you're at now.
We weren't.
Now you're fighting to make me believe that you weren't fucking Dan over the phone.
I wasn't.
How do I know you weren't fucking Dan off the fucking phone?
I wasn't.
Maybe you should fucking think about this shit beforehand.
I didn't.
I can't. I have... I can't even get to the game. It's just too much. You was phone fucking. Oh my god. Yeah, I know, Leo. Yeah, I got these allergies are fucking killing me. TLI, are you crying?
Yes.
Yeah, phone fucking is not a phrase people fucking use. It's stupid as shit.
Stop your stupid fucking bullshit with Dan! Because you have been in person with him!
I did!
You have been in person with fucking Dan!
With fucking Dan.
How do I know you have a second cock?
NPC Alfonso, I am Egyptian, actually. Do you know? I am Egyptian. I don't do this. I am Muslim.
You fucking great fucking long-ass fucking pig fucking faggot-ass dick that you fucking talk about all the time. You want to fucking give me? You shut your fucking mouth and I'll fucking damn.
Jesus Christ. And hello, Molly. Eddie Schmetti. Yeah, he's cry-yelling. He's cry-yelling. It's a rare Lorne. Hello, Herpes von Clustus. Come on. Come on, man. Herpes von Clustus. You guys gotta get this shit under control. Hello, Hetero Dan's Cock. Delally. Pee-wee. My god.
I'm done! If you don't shut the fuck up about him, you will never hear from me again.
I'm sure.
Okay.
And you get on a fucking phone right now.
Okay.
And you tell him. You tell him, and I'm gonna fucking tell him, and he is not ever gonna fucking pull his shit again.
Oh my god.
Oh my god, Lord.
Why is Lauren yelling at you? I don't know it.
Because he's your fucking boyfriend, Emma.
Actually, you know what?
What
a fucking cocksucker.
What happened?
He is never gonna fucking pull the bullshit that he has been pulling.
Before I get too much farther into this, I'm going to open up the Discord chat here. Hello. I'm now talking to Discord. Hello, guys. How are you doing?
Hey.
Hey.
How's it going?
Hi, this is, that's thing one.
Hello, weirdos.
Say hello to all the people. Good evening. you can hear the call, right?
Yeah, I can hear it fine.
Okay, great. I will keep playing it then.
And I want you on the fucking phone.
I just got a message, hold on. What is this?
I just left the message with Emma, letting her know that you said you are going to fuck Winnie.
What?
It's snitch. He's snitching.
That's what fucking Dan said.
I've always known you wanted my fucking woman.
Why?
Well, now you fucking snitch-ass piece of shit.
Fucking
what?
Yeah,
why?
I'm gonna do everything I can.
Shut up,
Lord.
Yeah.
Make sure. Winnie, do not say what. That's what fucking Dan said.
Dan.
I'm done dealing with this fucking bullshit. Dan's done playing with Emma. He's done playing with you. He's playing with me.
What's going on?
You want to say that again, then? He can fucking do it with somebody else.
Dan.
He's not doing that shit with me anymore.
Hello?
And Winnie?
Uh-oh.
Hi, Dan.
Dan? What's up?
Dan? Here he comes.
Hey, what's up?
Dan, I'm telling you right now, Dan.
Wait a minute.
I like you. I have liked you.
Did I hear
right? I've liked you for a long time, Dan. Fucking horseshit. This fucking horseshit that you said about fucking my woman has pissed me off.
Wait a minute.
Did you
have sex?
Hi, Emma.
You want my fucking woman, Dan?
No.
Do you want my fucking woman? No. You want to fuck? Do you want to fuck my woman?
Do you want Winnie? Do you want me?
Okay, sorry, just this fucking game real quick. Not only can't I not touch the ground, I can't even go near that part of the ground or I'll take damage. It's the dumbest shit I've ever seen. I can't
do
win.
Do you want to fuck my woman, Dan?
Yeah, do you want to fuck my woman?
No, I don't know. Emma, I don't know what's going on.
Hey, don't you ever fucking say that you do that.
He's lying, babe.
He's lying. I love you.
Fucking say, Dan.
I didn't say anything.
Dan, did you?
You fucking said it earlier! Don't fucking lie!
Dan,
Emma,
don't you ever fucking say it again!
Yeah, he did, he said it!
That's my fucking woman! And you're supposed to be with my fucking best friend!
How does he have any vocal cords at this point?
Say you're gonna fuck my woman again!
It's not even just like...
I didn't say anything yet.
It's not just that he... screams that loud. It's that he screams that loud for so long and like for so many years that he can still do it. He's
for like hours at a time.
Right.
It's insane.
Because I guess like I know when you're screaming like in like a band, there's a way that you're doing it that doesn't harm your voice, right? Is there like a specific way to do that, I assume?
Like an octave of some kind? I'm not sure.
No, but I mean like if you're like in a screamo band or something, you're not tearing your voice apart every time you go on stage. There's like gotta be a way to do it without hurting yourself. Whatever it is, Lorne's not doing it, is what I'm saying.
There's so many times I think about like how funny it would be to like be his coworkers and wonder why Lorne is hoarse all the time and he's just screaming at his fake girlfriends on the phone.
Right. Like, he's like, oh, my voice is my voice fucking hoarse. Complaining about it the next day.
Emma, I swear to God.
Don't fucking lie, Dan. You tell Winnie. No.
Oh, hello, Arado. Very good to see you.
Have to blow it all the fucking time.
Grumpy Sega Tech.
Don't fucking lie.
I didn't say anything, Emma. I swear.
This is not a driving game, Dan. Not a fucking game. I don't give a fuck if you've been face to face with my woman or not. You don't fucking make a move on my woman at all! Ever!
Yeah, Dan!
If you fucking ever do that again! If you ever fucking make a move on her again, Dan! And you are a face to face! I am telling you right now, it is not gonna be good face to face! You and I are supposed to be a good face to face with me and Winnie and you and Emma!
I would love a good face-to-face with Lorne. I would love a good face-to-face.
So don't you ever fucking make a move on my woman again!
God, so angry.
Yeah, Dan! Get it out of your fucking head!
Shut up, Winnie! Shut the fuck up! Get out of here, goddammit! Shut the fuck up!
Sorry, baby, I love you.
Emma, I swear I don't know what they're talking about.
Shut the fuck up, Winnie!
Shut the fuck up!
Oh my god. And yeah, James, his dogs are hiding right now.
Stop fucking lying, Dan!
I believe Lorne.
Seriously.
Emma, I believe Dan!
Emma, Lorne's lying!
You fucking lying, little bitch! Shut the fuck up and you start telling her the truth!
How could you do this? Winnie is our friend. I'm no friend of yours, Mexican! Winnie!
Shut up! Winnie, shut the fuck up!
Lorne's our friend.
Oh, Winnie's so racist.
I swear, Emma, that Lorne...
I can tell you both! Winnie, I can tell you, and Dan, I can tell you. Me and Emma have been longer than you two. Me and Emma are not gonna fucking lie to each other.
Right, Arrow? I wonder why Sadie's so skittish.
Yeah, seriously. Yeah. And also, like, he always... Like, he counts any time spent as, like... Like, it's positive time. It's like, if that time was spent screaming and yelling, it doesn't matter. It's still quality time. Like, because
yeah, like
I spent longer with Emma than you did. That means we're closer.
He's like, shut the fuck up, Winnie. And then later on, he's gonna be like, after all that time we spent together.
Yeah, seriously. And like, yeah, don't even acknowledge that all that time was spent being yelled at and threatened.
I just want
you two better get a fucking grip on what you're fucking saying and what you're fucking doing.
Dan, you know I'm not jealous. You know I share you with the guys and
No, but Emma, listen.
thing with the other girl, and just be honest. Were you just trying to make Lorne mad?
Emma, I love you, babe. I swear to God that I would never say that to Winnie.
I heard him, Emma. He did.
Dan, you better be honest with her.
I'm being honest with you, Emma.
No, you're not, Dan.
Dan, I love you.
I'm not gonna fucking dislike you if you're gonna be honest.
I love you too, Emma. He's fucking trying
to... If you're gonna be dishonest, I'm gonna dislike you.
He's trying to break us up, Emma.
I think...
I'm not trying to break you and Emma up.
Shut the fuck up, Warren.
Oh.
Shut up, fucking Dan.
Yeah, be quiet, you gay.
I'm not trying to break you and Emma up. I want you and Emma together. But I want you to fucking be honest with Emma.
Gay black.
Wendy. Wow, sound the alarm.
Shut up, Winnie.
Wendy, if you don't shut up, I'm gonna punch you in the fucking throat.
I think that'd be warranted. That'd be warranted.
You ever talk about that woman? My woman like that again, I'll punch you in the fucking face.
Dan, whatever.
And I won't fucking stop.
I just don't think you should be together alone with Winnie anymore because it causes problems.
I don't want
to
be
alone. Yeah, only Lauren's allowed to talk to this woman that way.
Right.
Yeah, well, you obviously fucking know because you can't stop your sexual bullshit.
I
didn't say anything.
Both of you.
Emma, you know how Winnie has eyes for me.
I know she does.
Well, I also know how you fucking try to fucking convince her.
One of my favorite Dan moments.
That you're
the
fucking best guy in the world.
I think I know what you're talking about.
I know how you don't fucking lead her astray. You keep her right on track. The fucking thing in the world about Dan.
Emma, you
don't fucking say no to her, Dan.
Emma.
You don't say no to her, Dan.
I believe Warren. I'm so...
No, Dan.
Emma, you know how good I look in a pair of jeans? You can't blame Winnie for this.
I've known Warren for 4 years, Dan. I've only known you for 2.
But you know I wouldn't lie to you. Who are you going to believe, me or that sack of shit?
That's my best friend. Whether or not I'm allowed to talk to him. You're not!
Shut up, Winnie, you fuck.
Dan, you fucking idiot.
No, you shut up.
Don't fucking talk to my woman like that, Dan.
Don't talk to my husband like that, baby.
Winnie. Lauren, I believe you. I don't know what's going on.
You don't believe me.
Emma, I don't want you thinking... Dan, shut up and let me talk. Emma, I don't want you think bad of Dan.
I clearly do.
I want Dan pulling the bullshit
liar.
That he's been pulling.
I think he's...
I like Dan. I like Dan. I don't want you and Dan to break up.
Dan doesn't like me.
I think it is wrong if you two did. I don't want Dan pulling the bullshit that he's been doing. I want Winnie to stop her fucking bullshit. Because Winnie is a large part of this.
And
she's gonna stop her fucking bullshit if she wants me.
Okay. Emma, listen. Just listen. Everybody, can I talk for 2 seconds, please?
Yes, you can, Dan.
Okay, let me just explain. Emma, you know how every time I fly out there, shut the fuck up.
Winnie, shut up.
Emma, you know how every time I go out there, Wendy is always bending over, puckering her asshole at me, stroking my dick.
Oh yeah, Moist Meat. For anyone who missed it, this is That's Thing 1 in the Discord chat, in Baked Salmon's Discord server with me.
Hello.
Trying to get it out of my pants. You've seen it.
I know.
She's all over me.
I know, and I try to keep it away from you.
You didn't know that.
Dan,
She took the balls out of my pants.
I don't doubt it, Dan.
Idiot.
Then how would I...
I'm sorry.
Dan, I don't doubt it, Dan. I don't fault you for it. What I fault you for is encouraging her.
Listen, Lauren.
When you are on the phone with her, Dan, do not encourage her.
Lauren,
Winnie?
Lauren.
Winnie.
God damn it.
Winnie.
What?
Winnie.
What?
If I ever hear of any of this fucking bullshit again, yeah. You fucking doing this shit.
Come on.
You have lost me for good.
I'm sorry, Dan. Were you
if
just trying
to... If I even hear of one fucking word of it, Winnie.
Okay.
You have lost me for fucking good.
Oh, of course.
I am tired of your fucking bullshit.
She's a beaner.
Of all these other fucking guys, Winnie.
Shut up, Winnie.
Do you understand me, Winnie?
Winnie, your beaner cousin raped me.
This fucking Mikhail bullshit, Winnie.
Just went to your house.
All this other fucking bullshit, Winnie.
What I like about Lorne is that he is as Matt at every single guy. Like, there is no, like, spectrum. If it's like, if he's even a little bit of a threat, he is this angry at them every single time. No variation.
Like, yeah, like, if you were, like, a fully homosexual dude around Lorne, he would still assume that you were gonna, like, do something with his women. It's bizarre. I will not, I'll never understand that concept.
No. Not at all.
Like, if you were a quadriplegic, like, wasn't Victor, like, paraplegic? And he was,
right.
Like, yeah, and he didn't like Victor either. Like, it's so bizarre.
Yeah, he says something like, tell that paraplegic, like, fuck, to shut up at one point or something like that.
I think Tiffany said at one point, like, any man with a set of hangers is a threat to Lorne, which I think is very accurate.
Yeah, that is painfully accurate. My God.
Do you understand me, Winnie?
Yeah, can we be friends? No, Winnie.
No,
you will never call Dan again, Winnie.
As a matter of fact,
if you call Dan and Dan didn't answer the phone, I am praying to God that Dan is going to tell me or Emma. If you ever call Dan again, then you and I are done. You will never call Dan again. The only one you will call is Emma. You better make friends with Emma. You better fucking pay Emma what you fucking owe her.
I'm not gonna give that.
I'm tired of you. I am tired of you fucking her. But she's been so good to you.
Lauren, I'd rather
you stop your fucking stupid bullshit, Liddy.
Fuck that. Right,
I'm fucking tired of it.
She's a Spanish hey, Betty.
Well, you're a white cunt bag.
There it is. There it
bullshit.
Is. That's one of my favorite parts.
Could you go back just a little bit?
I certainly
so
can. Yes.
Did he
who else we got in here?
Bag?
Oh, he certainly did. Yes. Surprise!
Yes.
Surprise! And hello, Callie,
so
lady.
Good. Hi.
Hey, Callie.
Hello.
Hi.
And hello. I'm just being honest. And did I say, I don't know if I said hi to Clark Vader, but hello, and Edgar.
Pixie Squad. What's up, Honest?
Lauren's mom's camel toe, naturally. Jill Pill. Kobe Wan Kenobi. Lauren's liver, looking rough, as always. God.
You're not fucking better than her!
There we go.
You're not better than I am, Winnie. Yeah, I am, and white.
You're gonna Winnie, you ever fucking call Dan again? You and I are fucking done. If I ever feel like you're cheating on me, you and I are done. So you better spend the next fucking 2.5 months concentrating on getting here to me so you and I are together.
Lauren.
Because all I can fucking do right now is go by what I fucking hear. And by the way I feel that you're acting.
Winnie.
But you better goddamn believe I'm going to be paying goddamn close attention because I know how you are.
Winnie, did you know that
you better fucking straighten your goddamn ass out.
Did you know I had to take my son in for surgery 3 days ago because his eye was itching, and they said that there was a piece of the coffee table still lodged in there.
Oh no!
And that was an extra $400.
That's a lot of money.
I have the bills. I have everything.
Make Dan pay
care.
It.
Fuck
I, Emma, I will pay that extra $400.
Yeah, make Dan pay it.
You're gonna pay. The rest of what have you had before?
What $400 do you have?
Yes, Dan should pay it.
What's going
Dan should not pay it!
Listen, Emma.
You don't get it!
Listen, Emma.
Oh my God.
Dan should not pay it!
Take my pussy!
Listen, I would
Winnie?
Rather...
What did you just say? What did you say, Woody? What the fuck did you just say?
Sorry, Dan, go ahead.
I think she called you.
Oh, what's going on? Sorry, sip of water. I don't think I've seen you in a while. And faceted dreams. What's up?
Kevin, eat your pussy! Did you just say that?
No, I think she called you white trash.
Yes! He's so drunk. That's how you tell him that!
Yeah, he's slurring his words so fucking bad.
What fuck did you just say?
Sorry, Dan, go ahead.
I think she called
you. Did you just tell him and eat your pussy?
Yeah.
Did you just tell him that?
No, I think she called you white trash.
I said you eat my pussy, Lauren.
Emma, I would rather you not talk to Wendy or Lauren.
I would rather.
Oh, I would rather.
Emma, that's going to happen. Because me and Emma are going to talk. Because me and Emma are the only ones that are honest with each other.
What if Emma doesn't want to talk to you, though?
So that is never going to fucking happen.
Oh, it's going to happen, baby.
It's going to happen, baby.
It's not going to happen.
Oh, I'm putting my left foot down. You best believe, bucko.
You put your left foot down, you put your right foot down, you put your fucking right arm out, you put your left arm out. I don't give a fuck what the fuck you do.
And you shake it all about.
Me and Emma are not going to stop talking because
shake it all
me and
about.
Emma are the only ones that are keeping you two honest.
So listen, bucko. Listen, I'm going to do whatever it's going to take. I'm going to do whatever it's going to take.
They're messaging you, Chief. Everybody wants you.
To stop you doing
this. Right, how about we do this? How about we do this? Emma and Winnie, you two can talk to each other. And me and Dan can talk to each other.
I hung up on her. No, you didn't.
Winnie? You better stop your goddamn bullshit.
What's the arrangement now?
How about...
Oh, Bella G, the beloved soundboard, I had to save for another time. I didn't want to be overzealous. I'm juggling a lot of balls tonight. Didn't want to had too many balls in the mix. Yeah, I got too many on my hands.
Emma and Wendy can talk to each other, and me and you, Dan, we can talk to each other.
I don't want to talk to Emma. She's a wet bag.
Jesus Christ.
Hello, dragon words.
Wait a minute. I can only talk to you. I can't talk to Emma or Wendy?
No, you can't talk to me.
Oh, no, you can. Dan, you can talk to her. You can talk to Emma, Dan.
No,
you can talk to Emma. You can't talk to Wendy.
Don't talk to Emma.
So if that arrangement's for me, then you can only talk to me or Winnie, and you can't talk to Emma.
Correct.
Yeah, until you two come out here.
No, forever.
I want to talk to you tonight, Dan.
Until you two come out here, and we'll face to face.
I don't think I want to come out there now, because you're being very antagonistic towards me.
Dan.
Bucko. I'm not being antagonistic towards you. I'm being antagonistic towards the situation.
I'm sorry, Dan.
Because I know of everything that fucking happened.
I'm sorry, Dan.
I can't help it if I'm attractive, Lauren. I can't.
He's so attractive.
You can't help it that you're attractive.
No, it's really overwhelming.
No, I can't help. I'm attractive.
Oh, he's about to say it.
I can't help it.
I can't help it. I'm attractive, Dan. But I still don't make more than your woman.
Lauren is pretty high.
No. Unacceptable. But I want to hear it again.
Ridiculous.
I can't.
You can't help that you're attracted to my woman?
No, I can't help. I'm attractive to your woman.
I can't help that I'm attractive, Dan. But I still don't make moves on your woman.
My God.
Lauren is pretty hot. Shut up, Emma. What? It's the truth. You're trying to start problems.
If you had to pick... If you had to pick between me and Lorne, who are you going to pick, Ella?
Lorne. Oh, Dan.
Oh,
I don't
Dan.
Know.
Goodbye. I'm done.
Emma!
Oh,
Dan,
no.
Don't say Dan.
Like
I
that?
I was saying Lorne because I was saying
that to me
Dan.
Is like he's watching a soap opera. That's what that sounded like to me. Emma, you're supposed to say Dan. Next time on As the World Turns. Like, it's so stupid.
But it's the truth. You're trying to start problems.
If you had to if you had to pick between me and Lorne, who are you gonna pick, Emma?
Lorne. Oh, Dan. I don't know.
Goodbye. I'm done.
Emma.
Dan.
You're supposed to say Dan.
I was saying Lorne because I was saying your name to ask you a question.
What?
What is wrong with Winnie tonight?
And what's going on, Poop Frog? Blop, blop.
Why is she so mean?
Oh, it's Poop Frog.
Hell yeah.
She hasn't had her fucking meds. She threw them in the fucking trash.
I threw them away, bitch. You fucking cunt. You brown-skinned bitch twat.
Winnie, stop it.
Winnie.
I gotta go to bed. I have work early tomorrow.
Oh, you gotta get up, huh?
Yes, I have to start at 5 a.m. I'm running an AA class.
Whatever, you fucking working class bitch.
Shut up, Winnie!
I'm sorry, I gotta go.
Oh. Hang up then, bitch! Oh, she did.
Winnie!
What?
Hang up then, bitch!
Stop fucking treating her like that.
Did you hear how she talked?
She's been nothing but nice to you.
Did you hear how she talked to me?
She has been your best friend. She has been the one that has fucking cared about you to try to get you away from the fucking drugs.
She just wants them for herself. She's a big old Mexican nostril snorting up all the good stuff.
You need to fucking stop when you guys are fucking wearing me out.
I love you.
Well, then fucking prove it.
Mwah.
Dan, are you still online, Dan?
Yeah, Dan.
I don't give good kisses on the
phone. Yes, he is.
Oh, no.
Please help me the Caleb boys.
Don't you dare. Don't you dare.
I had to do it to Thing One time.
For y'all who
just
don't
to make
know,
sure he's upset.
Kelly Slime Bucket Witch Lady does the best Kayla impersonation I have ever heard anywhere. It's just disturbingly good.
She always just sounds like she's gonna yawn. Like,
I didn't know if you hung up on me.
Come on.
Wow.
We're getting into anime territory now.
Please do. Yeah, it sounds like a lolly or some shit. Please,
hiya.
Please do. You're gonna think I'm stupid.
You're gonna think I'm stupid.
Oh my god.
So uncomfortable.
Good. I didn't know you hung up on me.
Oh jeez.
Okay, I'm done. I'm done. Sorry, that's getting really, really gross. I hate myself.
Alright, I'm not gonna play that game either.
Hello?
Dan.
Dan.
Is he still online, Winnie?
It says he is. I can see the number. It says, Dan, he's my man. On my phone.
Wow. Wow. Wow, gee, that gives it all away.
Hello?
Obviously, I'm not your man.
Hi, Dan. You're my husband.
Fuck you.
No, not you, Dan. Lauren's my husband. I love you.
Yeah, fucking prove it.
Prove
it. I love you.
Was your other boyfriend Dan?
That's a good question.
You want me to call him?
Still on the phone?
No.
Yeah, you certainly was on the phone for a couple of minutes after we and I fucking hung up, but weren't you?
I know.
Yeah, well, look at all the fucking issues you've caused.
I love you.
All these fucking issues you've caused between four fucking friends.
Again, delusional. Four friends.
I love you.
Absolutely delusional.
Yeah, well, why don't you fucking prove it?
I am. I called you back.
All right, now call Dan back. And I want to hear you fucking tell Dan. You have no interest in him at all.
Okay.
You are never going to call him. No, I'm not done.
So yeah.
You are never going to call him. Are you hearing me?
Yeah.
I'm trying. If you try to fucking call him before I am done talking to you, I'm gonna hang up.
Okay.
Well, I'm just telling him, you are never gonna call him again without me or Emma on the phone. Then you're gonna call Emma and you're gonna tell her that you're gonna help her.
No, let's call Dan first.
Call Dan, but you're gonna fucking stick to what I fucking said, because you and I are on the balance.
Hello?
You and I are very much on the edge.
We're living on the edge! Dan. Dan.
Hello?
Dan.
Hey, what's up, boo?
Hey, boo. I'm not interested in you sexually anymore. Lauren's forcing me to say.
Oh, you're saying that because
Hey, boo. Yeah. Hey, boo. There we go. Boo.
Hey, why are you calling me with Lauren
it's
on the phone?
Lauren's big moment.
We're supposed to have phone sex.
What's up,
the plan.
What's up, boo?
Now the three of us are going to
fuck. Who's Greek?
Dan.
What's up, boo?
With Lauren.
What's up, boo? Hey, obviously, boo. You're my woman,
boo.
And having phone sex.
You should go.
Now you tell me.
Why does he put so much
how's
stock in
gonna
phone
feel about
sex?
This, boo?
Go be with them, Lauren.
You can't.
It's because it's the only sex he's ever had, so he like has no choice but to put all his stock in it.
He treats it like it's the same thing as like actual sex. It's
he does
because he thinks it is,
and it's betrayal if anyone else does it.
Hey, boo.
Winnie. Next time you call me, make sure Lauren ain't on the line. I'll take care of you.
Oh, and who else do we have in here? Is that a guy named Kevin?
I knew a guy named Kevin once.
Oh, okay.
He's asking.
Oh no, of course. That's I would never. Accuse you of knowing someone named Kevin. But hello, how are you? Good to see you.
Well, I'm doing great. How about you?
Doing pretty good. Just hanging out. Listen to this this dickhole.
Okay.
Fucking Lauren.
Hello.
Fucking Lauren.
Dan.
Dan, you don't fucking worry me at all.
Hey, Emma. Hey, what's up?
Dan, I just heard what you told her. Ha ha, you didn't know I was gonna call Emma, Dan.
I was kidding. I was just trying to make Lauren mad.
Oops. Dan, that was kind of a mistake, wasn't it, boo?
What are you
talking
about?
Big mistake.
Dan, why are you doing this to me?
No, I didn't do anything.
Emma, he don't want...
Oh, Lorne Luciano is formerly printer. Okay. I honestly assumed you were Cornville Consigliere. I thought you just stayed on theme. But that's cool, too.
Where is Cornville? I haven't seen him in a little bit.
I don't know. I see him in Clark's every once in a while. I don't really, I don't know where he's been. Probably consiliarying somewhere.
Go be with Lauren.
Well, guess what?
Wow.
All you boos, I'm tired of your game. Have fun with you three. Bye.
All of you boos.
They all know he'll just answer again.
Fuck me, boo. Think he's crying?
Yes.
What do you want, Dan Lover?
Oh,
all that fucking
hi,
Dan
boo.
Lover.
Yeah, what do you want, boo boo? Big fucking boo boo.
Not boo boo.
That's not
big
how you say
fucking boo boo.
Big fucking boo boo seems on how I know that you and Dan have been having fucking phone sex.
Nuh-uh. Dan doesn't like me.
Oops. What a fucking big boo-boo.
Oops.
That's a big fucking boo-boo considering I figured it all out.
Oh my
Emma
god.
Emma just texted me.
You've been cheating on me for a long time.
He's really on something here.
Oh, he thinks he's really got it all figured out.
I hate that tone. I also hate whenever he's like, he does the I figured it all out. Like in the Ramona breakup call. Like she's like, your fake fucking girlfriend Ramona. And he's like, oh, looks like I figured it all out.
I figured that out too. No, he thinks this is like the end of the movie, like the villain's explaining what happened. He thinks he's got it all figured out. Oh, he's so stupid. God damn it.
You've been cheating on me for a long fucking time.
I want to hear that boo boo part again.
Oops, what a fucking big fucking boo boo, sing boo boo. Big fucking boo boo.
No, that's not how you say it.
Big fucking boo boo, sing song. Now I know that you and Dan have been having fucking home sex.
No, Dan doesn't like me.
Oops, what a fucking big boo-boo. That's a big fucking boo-boo considering I figured it all out.
Emma just texted me.
He almost sounds like he's about to break out into song.
I know, like whenever he gets sing-songy, I find it infectious. Yeah. I can't stop listening to it.
Oh, it's the best.
Oops, whoops. Big fucking boo-boo.
Me that's for a long time. Is, you've been cheating on me for a long fucking time.
On the phone with me, where he's like, I love
wanted
you.
Phone sex you with Dan, but you didn't want me and Emma to have anything to do with each other because you didn't want me to have phone sex with Emma. Oh, but it was all right for you and Dan to have phone sex with each other.
Nuh-uh.
Oopsie. I'm your lying sack of shit.
I love you, not Dan.
Yeah, well,
the biggest whoopsie of all, being a lying sack of shit.
Oopsie. Fucking lying sack of shit.
I love you, not Dan.
Yeah, well, you haven't proved it.
I'll prove it right now.
All you proved me is you love Dan.
I'll prove it now.
Get Emma on the phone.
No.
I'm not talking to Dan without him on the phone.
Suddenly appear.
You better call Emma first. You better fucking call Emma first.
One is here.
You're hurting my
Winnie, you are fucking bouncing on the edge of fucking over the fucking edge.
What?
Like, I get what he's saying, but you know. Yeah. Winnie, you're bouncing on the edge and over the fucking edge.
God.
Oh, what happened here?
So are you done having phone
to Wendy?
You think he's on. You, yeah, well, I'm on the fucking edge.
What? Yeah. You're hurting my
Winnie, hands. You are fucking bouncing on the edge of fucking over the fucking edge.
What?
Not you, Emma. I'm talking to fucking Winnie on that one.
Okay. Look, I'm real tired. I don't know what's going on. My life is falling apart, it seems. And then my friend told me that he's done with me, and I'm just done. I don't want to talk anymore tonight. Dan!
Oh, Emma, I'm not done with you. No, you and I are still good, Emma.
All right, I didn't do anything.
You're still my best friend, Emma.
I'm just trying to be cool, you know. I'm not.
What was that?
They're good until their next fight.
Right till the next fight, yeah. Then everything will blow up again. Then it'll be like none of this reconciliation ever happened.
He doesn't hurt anybody.
Dan as well, where he like doesn't have a problem with his homosexuality until they have a fight, and then like every slur in the world comes out.
Like up until he wants to be condescending. Yeah.
Anybody's shit. Dan!
Emma, right now, you little fucking piece of the cream compared to the other two.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm pretty upset myself. Dan!
Compared to my wife and your fucking boyfriend.
Still calls her his wife, though.
You're a piece of the cream, because as far as I'm concerned, your wife and your boyfriend and my wife have been cheating on us.
I'm agreeing with
sex with each other.
Stop. You give Lauren Armstrong a Virgin Hill pop.
Wow.
Yeah, well, I believe that you two have been having phone sex with each other. No wonder Dan has been so fucking willing and able to talk to you, Winnie.
I haven't been having phone sex with Emma.
No, he's not saying that.
Nope. You've been having phone sex with Dan.
Have you? No, but I try to.
No wonder you are so fucking wanting to talk to Dan
and then is so willing to fucking talk to you. Big fucking surprise.
And a big boo-boo.
You've been cheating on me, and Dan's been cheating on Emma.
Hello?
We're fucking phone sex with each other.
Dan. Dan.
Hello?
Dan.
Hey. Hey, Emma, what's up?
Have we had phone sex?
Never. Never.
Never.
Have you?
Never.
Dan? And I don't believe him.
I've never had phone sex with Dan, except for what you heard on the phone to make you mad. Why are you doing this, Winnie, every time you come around?
Maybe you should have thought twice about trying to make me fucking mad. This fucking internet fucking card bullshit has got to go if you and me and Dan and Emma are ever going to be able to get along with each other. The card bullshit has to fucking go.
Wait, did anyone even bring up COD?
Nobody did. Not a single soul brought up COD.
If you don't, then I will have nothing to do with any of you.
I'm hanging up. I'm done. I don't know.
I am not COD. I am Lorne.
Oh my god.
Does everybody understand this shit?
Understand what?
Oh my god.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I'm not fucking saying it again.
One of my favorite quotes from Lorne is the, I'm not Mr. Penis.
I am not Mr. Penis. I love how often he has to correct people to make sure they know he's not Mr. Penis.
I love
that. Not that COD person.
Where they refer to Mr. Penis and then Ramona's like, what is that? Hold on, let me Google it. And he's like, Ramona, don't do it.
Don't, yeah, that's when she's like, I'm gonna look up Mr. Penis. Like, well, I don't know what this is. Let me look this up. Ramona, no, don't do it. I am not Mr. Penis. I am not Mr. Penis. Pause.
Quad.
It's just me.
Well, you're gonna stop playing ignorant. You're gonna stop trying to impress your fucking fuck over the phone boyfriend, Dan.
He's not my boyfriend. I've never had phone sex or any sex with him. I always try to flirt with him, and that's it. And that's
all. How do I know? How do I know?
You keep hanging up on us.
Exactly, Nick Golo. Mr. Penis is an urban legend.
So I can't prove it to you.
Yeah, well, how are you going to fucking prove it to me, Winnie? How are you going to prove it to me?
I'll tell
you. By all the fucking words you say?
Shut
how
up.
You think about Dan all the fucking time?
What's up, M1A? Matthew Burgess, Michael Mendoza?
Call Dan. And then you say you're on and then you'll know.
What are you going to say to you? What about your sister? What about the shit that your fucking sister says? Are you fucking kidding me? You better stop playing the goddamn fucking game.
Oh, my God.
You are never to talk to Dan alone on the fucking phone again. If you do and I find out about it, I'm breaking up with you. For good. So.
All right. I'm eager to get to the real, like, this next one with the real rage in it. Because he just is so guttural. So I'm just going to hop right into that one. This is Make Mimi's Asshole.
Oh, God, yes.
Oh, boy.
When I was on the phone with you, with other guys, that's what you fucking hate, is because I know what you've done.
Sounds like he's been crying.
Yeah. He's about to cry a little more.
I didn't cheat on you.
Oh boy.
And I think you are being way too mean, and you need to check yourself.
Do I need to check myself? Or do you need to have fucking Gigi clean? You fucking vagina again. Are you fucking kidding me?
I'm sorry.
Are you fucking, kidding me?
I'm sorry.
Are you fucking kidding me?
I'm sorry.
It's your fucking vagina,
like...
goddammit!
I'm sorry.
The place that only I should fucking be.
And that's my favorite. And that's maybe my favorite thing he's ever said. Right there. It's your fucking vagina, goddammit, a place only I should fucking be. And I right after he ramps up the "Are you fucking kidding me?" the Rambo, "Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me?"
The build.
He builds like that. Are you fucking kidding me?
Are you fucking kidding me? Are you fucking kidding me? Oh my
God. Yeah, it started to get very, like, guttural.
Right, like, I like when he gets demonic like that. And hello, Amanda James. I'm going to have to hear that again.
Oh, please.
Yeah.
I
like when it, like, cuts out and it cuts back and it's like, vagina again.
And I think you are being... Wait,
Selene,
I need to check yourself.
Do I need to check myself? Or do you need to have fucking Gigi clean?
Clean what?
Your fucking vagina again. Are you fucking kidding me?
I'm sorry.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Sorry.
Are you fucking kidding me?
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. You opened your fucking vagina to at least three fucking guys that was there today. Three.
I'm sorry.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Sorry, baby.
I'm sorry.
Why does he pronounce vagina so weird?
I don't know.
Because he knows how to make anything sound like a threat. He knows how to make anything sound sexually threatening.
Vagina.
Vagina.
He says he says a few words weird. Like, he also says Canada. Instead of Canada, he's like, Canada.
Canada. Canada. He likes to break down those syllables.
Jesus. Horrible.
Damn.
It's horrible.
Horrible.
I'm sorry. So sorry.
I think she's not. Just a hunch.
Lauren, hang up. But I'm calling back.
Oh my God. Fucking
hell. I got so enraged. I wonder if he's throwing something.
Certainly.
Poor dogs.
Poor fucking dogs.
Hang up. And I will call you right back.
That's what gets me so mad.
Somebody send me a message. I don't know if it was you.
I don't know if it was you.
Hey, call me again. I'm in the mental house. Hello, Mrs. Winnie Armstrong. How can I help you?
Who is that you just sent me a picture of?
Me. Rebecca. And oh no,
Wow. Oh, it's the dimples.
Oh, is this the dimples conversation? Well, it better not.
It didn't look like you.
I'm on the left of my tongue out.
What?
I'm on the left with my tongue out.
All right, let me hang up and I'll go to your bag. Let me look again. I can't look at it without fucking hanging up. I'll call you right.
This is the woman he wants be up there with him.
Yeah, like for like long term. And this is their dynamic? Like how?
I didn't want to look at the fucking picture. I didn't get to look at the picture.
My problem is that you don't believe it's me when it is.
Then stop and think when you send me pictures. I want to see your dimples.
No! Sometimes I don't smile!
Every picture you send me, I want to see
your dimples.
That's so infuriating.
I can't believe you're trying to do that.
Dimplegate, for real.
God!
Oh my God.
What? To make you smile?
No! You should be able to recognize me. If I want to look sultry for you, I will. Bitch! Some people have dimples that don't show all the time. Like me!
Oh, horseshit. Horseshit.
When
you have dimples like you fucking show me now,
horseshit.
There's no way to escape them fucking dimples.
Okay, I really just wanted that real, like, anger. Let me, what else do I want to hear? Angry Lauren voicemails, the Raptor Bacon video. This is just the audio from that. Because I really like them compiled like that.
Well,
touch on you again. The fucking possibility of, or hopefulness of being able to talk to you. That fucking double dose of fucking medication that you had earlier did not help. I sent you a message saying that I guess you don't want me in your life. You sure didn't give a fuck about calling me. Sorry I sent that. I know you're medicated. I'm just so mad and frustrated that nobody is telling me anything. Victor's right there and he never called me back. Let me know anything. He said he called Emma or texted him or whatever. Told her. And here I am fucking clueless about what's going on with you. You never called me. In the last couple days, you've been avoiding my calls, ignoring my calls. I'm fucking royally pissed off about it, and it's gonna stop. It's fucking bullshit.
Bullshit. Bullshit.
I hate being shut out.
I love the music.
You're shutting me out.
I know. It's always
so. You need to stop shutting me out.
Well, dear. Well,
when I call, I expect to nail that. I'm gonna get you a voicemail instead of you answering the phone. It's fucking sad.
Fucking sad. It's fucking sad.
You never call me back. It really fucking sucks, Debbie.
It fucking sucks, Debbie.
Instead of me getting your voicemail all the time, it'd be nice if you started answering the phone.
It's almost like she doesn't want to talk to him.
It's exactly like that, isn't it?
Weird.
Like, if I didn't want to talk to someone, this is how I would be treating them, too.
It's taking a toll on me because you're not giving me any attention at all. You're avoiding my calls and just listening to my voicemails.
But they're funny, Lauren.
That shit fucking sucks. Instead of just listening to my voicemails, why don't you call me after?
I don't know why, but right now I'm picturing, like, Lauren on the piano, naked, and doing this voicemail.
No, I don't want to miss you.
Like a cartoon
you.
Version or something.
Oh, absolutely. God. Absolutely.
That's what I'm getting.
Well, you got to do something. I knew you wouldn't answer the phone.
No, here we
you
go.
You never do, unless there's somebody else that's calling other than me. There seems to be quite a fucking pattern with you and everybody else. Stalking, Debbie? Stalking, really? This guy that you're fucking renting your fucking house off?
Yes, Poop Frog, these are records behind me.
You don't think that maybe he might have cameras in your fucking house? This guy is fucking disgusting, and you just chose him over me. Good fucking job, and here I thought you were smarter than me. I thought you cared about me.
She is.
And you're telling him fucking Will and Winnie not to contact me. That fucking bullshit is disgusting. Since when are you fucking ruling Winnie and Will's life? All because of your fucking boyfriend that you have there, where you spent maybe 10 minutes with me today, all fucking day with this cocksucker. The one that's putting a wedge between me and you, that's causing all this fucking friction, because you want his ass there. You want his ass there, but you can't be on the phone with me.
My God, the music.
The music.
You have to have him there. Really, Debbie? Really?
Really?
You spend enough time with this fucking piece of shit. You want me to get rid of this motherfucking piece of shit?
Someone is spiraling.
About answering the fucking phone when I call.
Yeah.
The
music makes it seem like it's a biblical meltdown.
Yes.
To bring you a cup of coffee.
Bring on the crescendo.
When you're on the phone with me, when you know that I hate him.
Which is funny because it's about Angelo, you know?
Yeah.
Fucking Andrew.
You give a fuck about me, you think about this shit. But I guess you don't fucking give a fuck about me. Because you just fucking let me go saying that I'm stalking you. Fuck you. This bitch is the one that's fucking stalking you, and you're blaming me for his shit. Open your fucking eyes and get off the fucking medication. Hey.
Jeez.
No, I had medical advice from Lauren. On the first ring and then the voicemail. What's up? What is up with that, huh?
What is up with that?
Anyway, good morning to you. Give me a call back.
I don't know if he does it in this one, but my favorite voicemail is the one where he, like, the voicemail starts. He's like, I don't know why you didn't call me back. And then he sneezes and then he says, sorry, I sneezed. Must be allergic to your bullshit.
It's
good line. So good. Every time I laugh.
I'll tell you about yesterday's events with her. All right. Bye. Hey, Victor.
There we go.
Tell Winnie that was a real fucking smart move throwing away Rhoda's phone. Now two fucking girls have it. Don't know who the fuck they are, but fucking real great fucking job.
Fucking job.
She's not fucking calling me back, so she obviously doesn't want me. Okay. This is the way it is. You're fucking lying your ass off to me about your fucking phone. Because every fucking time that I call your phone, I get the voicemail. But you have answered your calls when other people have called you.
Music. And hello, Edamame.
And you told me that sometimes you are just near it and you answer it. Sometimes you're not and you don't. That's fucking bullshit. It's a fucking lie. And you know it. But you fucking told me a lie to try to cover it. What the fuck is going on? Why is it that everybody in this little fucking circle brings my calls to their voicemails?
What?
It's kind of fucked up.
Was that even a sentence?
Barely. I guess he's saying they're like avoiding his calls, like letting my calls go to voice, like letting my calls become voicemails.
Fucked up, a lot fucked up. So you lied to me the other day. When you're trying to teach me not to lie, there's not been one time that any of you have answered my calls directly. And you have really fucking lied to me because of today. It's fucking pathetic. What the fuck? Hey, Debbie. There's some really fucking shit that's going on. And I need to talk to you. Winnie's talking fine. She says she discharged herself from the hospital. She says she's coming up here. Victor says he's leaving, getting the hell out of there and going back to wherever his home is. I don't know.
Yeah, seriously, have another beer, Lauren.
I need to talk to you. If you can call me back, I would appreciate it. Bye. Hey, it's me.
Thank you, Poop Frog.
I just tried calling.
Oh, hey, it's me.
Casey/Wendy. And she changed her number.
That bitch.
So, if you could go over there today, find out what her number is, shake her up, whatever you gotta do.
Oh my god.
I wanna talk to her again. I want information from that bitch.
Oh, that bitch.
That is fucking shit.
Information from that bitch.
Bullshit. I want her.
How dare she change her number?
Probation officer in the state police.
if you could do that for me, I would really appreciate it. Okay. Thank you. Give me a call back. Bye.
Emma, can you call me back? I need your help. I can't get over my voicemail. Winnie changed it over to fucking Spanish, and I can't get it changed back. Will you please call me back?
Oh, no. Hold on.
My voicemail. Winnie changed it over to fucking Spanish,
wait,
and I can't get it changed back. Will you please call me back?
Oh, fucking moron.
Oh, my God.
Oh, shit.
I really want to talk to you. I really want to talk to you on the phone.
No, really?
I
had no idea.
And I lied to you, and I want to be honest with you about it. I don't want to do that anymore. I want to be able to tell you the truth every time that you ask me something. And I'm sorry that you're having to work with me to get me to these points. Sometimes I get scared. Sometimes I get nervous. And I'm sorry for that. Sometimes I get defensive. And I'm sorry for that.
Oh, my God.
If you call me back, I would really appreciate it. I'm having a problem with doing anything because I'm so upset about last night.
Picked up on that.
And I had a long talk with Winnie this morning. And she helped me out on a lot of things.
I'll bet she did. Did she shriek in your ear for 17 hours?
And I really need to talk to you.
Is that how she helped you? Because that's how I think she probably helped you.
So I really appreciate it if you would call me. Bye.
Bye.
I know that nothing that I say fucking matters to you, okay?
Oh, boy.
Nothing at all. It's obvious that nothing at all fucking matters to you what I say.
You really catching on.
Friends down there, you can party all fucking night long.
Oh, he's figuring
all
it
your
out.
Fucking
he's putting it all together.
All your fucking guys down there, what?
Yeah, the drunker he is, the closer he gets to figuring everything out.
I think he really, honestly gets smarter when he's drunk.
He really does.
I think I said it here in Discord the other night, but I love when he's like really drunk and he'll just come out of nowhere with, isn't that right, Grandpa?
Yeah,
right. He knows. Yeah, he's aware. He's far too aware for the way he reacts to it.
I can't remember if it was Batsby or Tiffany or whoever said it, but the absolute best definition for Lorne I've ever heard is willful ignorance.
Oh, for sure. Yeah. Yeah. There's no other way to put it. He's like, he wants this to be real so bad. He's willing it into existence.
Exactly.
And I don't give a fuck. You can't pay attention to what you're fucking doing with me. I don't give a fuck. Just know
really
that I know you're
like
fucking some new fucking Xavier.
He seems to give a fuck.
This bullshit.
It seems to.
Every fucking thing you've done today screams fucking Xavier.
screams Xavier. Fucking Xavier. Hello, Shin's Koala. This is these are a few of the denizens of the Bake Salmon Discord server. This is a guy named Kevin, Callie Slimebucket Witch Lady, and That's Thing One in here with me right now. Anyone was curious? Callie Slimebucket Witch. Yeah.
Slimebucket bitch. I love it when Michael's Teacup calls me Slime Bucket. It makes me feel really, like, really good about myself. And also,
kind
of, like, turns me on in a way, you
know?
Yeah,
it's good to get an occasional self-esteem boost.
Oh, I love
from
it.
From your friends, Callie. Yeah.
Can I plug
Oh, please
Callie
do. Go right ahead.
Callie Slime Bucket Witch Lady has recently released a wonderful song on her channel. Please go check it out. It is hilarious, and it's also incredibly good. So, best combination.
Thank you. It's
yeah, go for it.
It's just me squawking. talking about Lorne and bullshit. Well, not really talking. I'm screaming.
Shut up, Callie. You sound great. You know you do.
Booking your inner Lorne.
I know you. Any fucking bullshit, a fucking way. That just fucking really pissed me off because I know there's some fucked up bullshit going on. Don't think that I don't fucking know. I know. And I'm so fucking sorry right now.
Yeah, Amanda James, that's another one of my favorites where he's like, I will find you and I will fucking puke on you.
I love that one.
Oh my God.
Did I trust you with my fucking information? Now, don't you feel fucking proud of yourself?
Bet she does.
I can fucking go to fucking bank tomorrow and fucking
tomorrow?
Nothing be there.
Yes, Poop Frog. This is me talking
Callie Slime Bucket Witch Lady.
Talking right now.
Because if you got anything to fucking do with your fucking Xavier, you're a stupid motherfucker
music's
anyway.
Back.
Thanks, Rob, for fucking showing me that you really fucking cared about me. While you're all fucking guys down in fucking Florida.
Oh my God.
Fucking full of shit. God. Bullshit you fucking handed me. Fucking bullshit.
Can one of you post the link to Callie's channel in the chat? Shin was asking for it.
Yeah, I'll take care of it.
Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, thanks.
I know you wouldn't answer the phone. You never answer the fucking phone. Fucking hiding away like you always do. Probably with your friends within your all-night fucking party.
Oh, my God.
Just want to let you know that I figured, you know, it seems really fucked up to me that you did all that fucking shit before to get my attention. You got my attention, got me away from Winnie, but then it seemed really weird that Winnie all of a sudden fucking said she was gonna be on her way up. And then she wouldn't even listen to anything I was saying, even when I told her, get your ass up here, and you and I will get married.
How much like she doesn't want to marry you, Lauren?
So don't think I'm not fucking...
It's starting to seem that way, isn't it?
See what is fucking going on.
Oh, and hi, Scarlet Ebony. Very good to see you, too.
I tried to fucking look past it and see you. And say, no, alright, it's fucking blue. So I just fucking look past it and give that Debbie a chance. Well, this fucking crap that you're pulling now, fucking, you were acting so interested in me before, and you fucking, you did all this shit, and then you fucking sent me the fucking postcard, and I finally fucking got the postcard.
What's up, Ben Stein?
And...
Hi, Betty.
Now you're fucking all this fucking shit of this friendship and what the fuck ever.
Where the fuck is Lauren
going with
this?
Someone else?
Literally nowhere.
Nowhere.
I think it's
the train never left the station.
You know, I do know that Winnie loves me. I do know that. But the fact of the matter is, she's caught up in some fucking bullshit, which she can't come out and see me because it was part of a fucking game. Between, I don't know who the fuck is involved, but it's fucking pathetic. But I think you're part of the fucking game too. You're part of the fucking game too because of this fucking bullshit you've been fucking playing.
No way.
Have your friend have fun with your fucking beach friends? Have your fucking date? Don't give a fuck. You don't give a fuck enough to send me a fucking message? I don't give a fuck either.
So, what did her postcard say? Wasn't it like, wish you were here, glad you're not?
With you and your fucking...
Yes, the postcard from Debbie when she was on vacation. Wish you were here, glad... Like, you said, wish you were here, glad you're not. Well, that don't even make no fucking sense.
I will always think the best punishment for Lorne is exactly what Tiffany did, where she got him really invested in her. And then she cut him off and would barely talk to him. I think that is the best punishment, Lorne.
Because he just toils away, and then when you get to talk to him again, he's so much more irritated.
He, like, wanted to talk to her so bad, and she would not give him nearly as much time as, like, any of the other catfish, and I absolutely love that punishment.
I mean, that's the way to do it, I think. Like, if you're going to catfish him, like, for real, the best way to do it is to give him a little bit and then withhold. Like, you know, get him, like, make him want more. If you're just giving in all day, then you're just, you know, you're just with him all day.
He's just naked, pacing, and sending angry texts and voicemails. Like, that's the best punishment for Lorne, in my opinion.
Right. It is. Yes. It is. The loneliness in between.
Beach friends and your fucking dates. Hey, it's me. I really want to talk to you, okay?
Hey, it's all. He's a little bit sadder in this one.
A little bit.
Lorne. Like, he was crying. I don't know what you're mad about.
Are you crying?
Lorne.
Are you crying?
Yeah, yes.
Calm down.
And I really think we ought to talk.
Calm down.
Calm down, Lorne. I don't like confrontation. I just want to spend time with my friends.
Like, please, God, leave me the fuck alone.
Whatever. As far as I know, you met somebody at the fucking, your little early morning fucking outing that you had. Overnight outing. Mm-hmm. And right now you're on a fucking
overnight outing. Ooh.
That's why you're being a fucking asshole to me.
Ooh.
You're blocking me or fucking just not answering me. So whatever. What the fuck ever, Debbie? Fucking pathetic. Hi.
Oh, and now he's sad again.
I want to apologize to you for being such a baby bitch.
Mm.
Personally.
Yes.
Baby bitch. What?
So, let's hear that again.
I want to apologize to you for being such a baby bitch. Personally.
Oh, I love that.
I'm so sorry.
I'm so sorry.
It's not the way I want to act. I'm sorry. Having such a hard time changing some shit about me. Because I didn't drink and drive last night, though.
No, of course not.
That's a plus.
I told Tony.
Yeah.
I wish I wouldn't have done that. Just hearing his voice irritated me.
Uh-huh.
So, yes, some things about me are changing. It's taking a minute. Or two.
10.
Please be patient with me.
20.
I am trying to change my shit. It's just coming slow.
We got Stanley Kendall in the chat saying, "My cock is hard." Thanks, Stanley Kendall.
God damn. Stanley.
Stanley.
Oh, no.
You better take your deviancy elsewhere. Take that to Clark Vader's stream. Get that shit out of here.
Wait.
I'm just farting.
Oh,
Big
grandson.
One does the best Dan Shrek.
Mm. Oh, please do.
Please do it.
Oh, Dan Shrek. For those who do not know, Dan Shrek is the greatest decoy that has ever graced TCAP. I will fight anyone in a green shirtless if you disagree.
Yes.
How you doing, Stanley? Okay, why don't you pour us some drinks, you know? I'll be right back. Do you want to hop in the hot tub? Why don't you strip? You know, take your shirt off. I'll be right back. I love it. There are two words that describe Dan Shrek's character in TCAP. It is power bottom. That's it.
Absolutely.
Yes, 100%. That's a good way of putting it. Never thought of him that way. Thank you.
He's an alpha bottom.
Right.
Ooh. So great.
He has control from the ground. Holds it down.
He made some of the predators like blush. Like, so many of them were just kind of like, "Holy shit, this is the
kind
guy,
of into him."
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. He turns on the charm. He's flirty. He actually like gets a little like close to like them, like physically, like kind of breaks the space a little bit where it's I don't know.
Yeah, it's great. I absolutely love Dan Shrek and TCAP, man. It's such a great decoy.
Yeah.
Don't really pay enough attention to the decoys, I don't think. Or at least I don't.
There were some really great ones, but in my opinion, I think Dan Schreck had like the best kind of flirtatious energy, you know, like when it came to luring in these predators. And it just, in my opinion, there's a couple of the female decoys that were amazing, you know, like I made the joke the other night in Discord that they could have gotten any predator in the entire sting into the Kentucky house with the coochie cutters that Casey was wearing.
You know, damn it.
The only time I ever hear that is when it comes out of your fucking mouth. And every time I forget about that phrase, then you say it again.
I know.
And then it's stuck in my head again.
Again. But it's like they would be like, they could have been talking to an Asian girl or whatever, and they would have like seen Casey sitting there by the door in those little shorts, and they would have been like, I'm going in that house.
Yeah,
I have to. They wouldn't even questioned it.
Gotten some passersby.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, don't forgive her for not being Asian.
Good lord.
You were just driving by and some, you know, pretty little girl just waved you in the house. What a lucky guy you are.
What a lucky guy you are.
Right now, I am so fucking sorry that I trusted you with all my information. I don't know what the fuck is going to happen. Thanks a lot for fucking pulling your stupid fucking bullshit.
Oh.
Enjoy your fucking party ass fucking night.
I am so sorry for being an asshole last night.
He always comes back to apologize.
I said just bad because I only had not a very long time with you yesterday, and I was looking forward to having some time with you.
I too yell at people I haven't talked to.
Me being a bitch.
Vagina. That is the best way to pronounce how he's saying it, Amanda. Vagina.
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 Horrible.
It's horrible.
The place where only I should fucking be.
But I did not go anywhere. I did call Tony. I hated myself for calling Tony after I called Tony because
he probably made fun of you.
I don't know, since that guy just grosses me out now.
What?
I hate to think of it that way, but sucks. So I'm getting there little by little.
Is that what
so
this
I don't
is?
Don't want to lose faith in me, okay? But I don't think I could do it without you. So, hopefully you'll take me off block.
Oh, this is why. This is why he's so neutered, because he's been blocked.
Ignoring me. And I don't blame you.
He's been starved for attention.
Alright. Hopefully I'll talk to you soon. I got a dentist appointment at 8 o'clock.
Thank God. Go to it.
Hopefully you'll say something to me before I go there.
Yeah, his teeth are still fucked up.
Right, yeah. Didn't work.
Right.
Did the dentist just look in his mouth and say, hey, no thank you. Have a nice rest of your day. No.
Get that fucking buck tooth bonanza out of my office.
Yeah, get this guy out of my office. You don't even deserve to have teeth.
Go figure. I get the phone number that had my voicemail on it. I think I might have just stumbled upon the reason why you haven't fucking called me all day and why you've done so little to call me all day.
Oh my god.
You never had any intention to come on and fucking meet me.
Whoa, what?
No way. Come on.
Quite obvious.
You gotta be kidding me.
It's fake.
I'm fucking. Jesus Christ. I'm so fucking beside myself about this shit. It's unreal. I'm fucking believable. Well,
it's almost like this whole thing's fake.
What the fuck?
It does seem that way.
You had your fucking fun with me. Enjoy your fun with the next fucking guy you're talking to right now on the other fucking line. On whatever fucking line you're talking to.
That line.
Playing your fucking game. You fucked up fucking bullshit game.
Wow.
Fuck you.
Oh my god.
Yeah, that's venomous. That's a vitriol there. He is pissed. All right. I'm going to switch over to this next thing I wanted to play. Oh, actually, yeah, let me, I have to share it in here, too. So I'm putting on a little music first. Where is that tab now? Boom. All right, now this one is another thing Raptor Bacon posted, but it's like the Ramona call where he's like making up that he has a date and tries to get her to stop going on the date with a therapist. Yeah.
Yes.
He's mad and he cries, and I just really wanted to hear it again. So let's get a little taste of that.
Forever.
Me too. Like when he posted it, I was like, yeah, this is the one.
I'm really happy for him. You know, I am really happy for him that he's going. You know, that he's going to get back out there. I've told him that this is what he should do. You know, I mean, I'm half his age. I live hundreds of miles away. And, you know, I don't see, you know, between me, I don't see what I'm supposed to think that I'm getting out of this situation with him besides getting yelled at on a regular basis. But, I mean, I think that, you know, I think for him what would be best is for him to go out with this girl who he's talking about. And that's me saying this to you, not as someone who wants to go out on dates. That's me saying this as a person who's looking at it objectively. What's best for him in his situation is to be dating girls who are there. We know that this is how he would be if he were to drink. And so, I mean, it's, you know, it's completely legal.
Every day, matter how it disappears, how he will be.
Oh no!
You're listening to a therapist that doesn't know shit about me.
Lauren,
that's right.
He's trying to put shit in your head.
Lauren.
He's trying to put shit in your head about me because he saw me a fucking loser to somebody that he's getting personal with that he's not supposed to be getting personal with.
Wait, he has no interest at all. I can't really understand what he's saying because he's got a bad connection.
Hey, maybe I'll try giving me a call.
Wait, Warren,
say again? Maybe I'll try giving me a call.
I still don't understand. Giving him calls?
He wants you to give him a call.
Maybe he should think about the fact that there's probably a reason why I didn't call him.
Yeah,
because of the therapist.
Oh, Tavarcio, yeah, the game isn't frozen. I've just got really distracted by Lauren. I mean, I just got a lot going on right now.
I mean, that's pretty understandable.
Yeah, I think so.
It has nothing to do with the therapist. It has everything to do with you.
It has everything to do with you cheating on me with that piece of shit. That's what it has to do with.
I'm cheating on you. Why don't you find someone who won't cheat on you? If you're going to say I've cheated on you, why don't you find someone who won't cheat on you, if that's what you're saying?
Why don't you just not cheat on me?
If you have to ask that question, then you shouldn't be in the relationship, I think.
Why
don't you just not cheat on me?
One of my favorite beta male quotes that he has ever said is, "When is the sex with other guys gonna stop?"
Oh my god. Yeah, eventually.
Say that is pathetic.
Oh my god. It's so depressing.
That is really depressing.
Yeah. You've done it. Why would you do it?
First of all,
why would you tell me how perfect this therapist is? And he doesn't even act like a therapist.
First of all, are you wearing the headset? Because I can't really understand what you're saying all that much.
Well, then call me.
What?
Call me.
Call me.
I'm on the phone with you.
You can't understand what I'm saying. If you were to call me directly, you'd be able to understand what I'm saying.
Lauren, take the headset off and I could understand you.
I take the headset off and I gotta take the phone away from the window where I get the good signal.
Yes, exactly, Chris Hansen. This is the call where Lauren pretends to be going on a date to try to convince Ramona to not go on her date.
Lauren, just take the headset off.
Hang on. Can you hear me any better?
I wish I couldn't.
Lauren, I have
the problem that we're having is that you're going out with this therapist.
Lauren, it has nothing to do with the therapist.
The therapist has a lot to do with it. That's where my problem started from. Because of this therapist. You brought the therapist in.
Honest, I'm not sure where this is in the dump. This is just a repost of it on Raptor Bacon's channel, which is how I was reminded of it. I can never remember what the calls are called, especially the Ramona ones. They're all kind of similar.
Lauren,
I've not heard this one in forever. The last time I heard this call was the Ember stream, like forever ago. So it's been over a year and a half since the last time I heard it.
Yeah, like it should be in there somewhere.
Parents did. Second of all, Lauren, I would rather be single than to have to deal with this kind of nonsense on a daily basis. You screaming, cursing, being controlled.
We're not going to deal with this shit on a daily basis if you just stop it with these other guys. That's all I've asked for you and for you to do. Stop it with these other guys so that I don't get jealous or I don't have anything to worry about. But you're constantly making me worry about this stuff.
Lauren, you've been jealous of TV shows, Friends in Texas, Female Friends in Texas, and 96-year-old
grandma. That was back then. I'm a whole different person now, but you wouldn't know because you haven't been spending time with me. You know why? Because you've been spending your nights up all night talking to whoever. But it certainly wasn't any time with me. Yeah. You know, you haven't known me for the last 2 months.
Lauren, go on your date and have fun.
If you go over to this therapist's house, I'm not going to want a thing to do with you. Because it'll just mean you cheated on me again.
Lauren, go on your date. You have a date, go on your date.
Are you planning to go over to the therapist's house?
I was not going to go until I found out that you have a date, and then I said, well, I have a date.
I don't want to go on this date. I want us to be back together and to talk. So we can get this shit straightened out.
Lauren, go on.
That's what I want. No, I'm not going. I'm not going on the date.
Lauren, go on the date.
I'm not going on the date.
You can go on your date, Lauren.
Just go on the date, Lauren.
I'm not going on the date.
Lauren, just go and have fun.
Please go on a date.
Enjoy yourself, Lauren. Go on a date.
No.
And then, so we can all know how
I'm
it happens.
I'm not going on the date.
Right.
Well, that's on you.
Oh, hey, what's going on, Bitter Almonds? Oh, and for whoever asked me what my favorite album was back there, it's this one, the D'Angelo's Voodoo, and not just because of the cover. I really enjoy it. This one.
I don't know why you're going to cancel on someone on the last minute.
Because my loyalty is to you.
Your loyalty is not to me when you've already scheduled the date. Go on it, though. Don't cancel on the last minute.
When I made the date, at least we were broken up. We weren't still together. I'm not going on the date.
Lauren, maybe you should call Jen and cancel the date right now on three-way. That way Ramona knows you're serious.
Yeah.
What?
That's a good idea.
That's probably the best way to do it. Like, if they're going to call off the date, just do it on three-way. It's easy.
What?
What Emma just said. That's a very good idea.
No, I didn't hear what she said. I get people on my phone. I got to take that blow test in about 15 minutes.
I said
Emma,
that.
Huh?
I know. I muted myself. I said you should just call Jen on three-way and cancel your date so Ramona knows you're serious.
Well, I don't have Jen's number. I get a call from Tony, and Tony has to call her. Tony knows her.
Well, I'm still trying to give her the number, and you can't.
Is this a blind date?
Call Tony right now.
I guess that's what Lauren's trying to insinuate, that like Tony has the number and they're just meeting somewhere for a blind date, which I guess is not out of the question, but I just think he's lying.
Oh,
he's
absolutely
full of shit.
Yeah.
He's completely making this up.
Right.
Lying out of his ass.
And a couple of people in the chat are asking for the Silent Rick call. I know which one that is, but I know it also has copyrighted music in it. If you give me like a minute, I will. I know the part with Rick doesn't have music in it, so if I can find that part, I'll definitely play it, because I also think it's very funny.
Oh, good. I don't think I've heard that one. I know
it's
been
really silly
for a while.
Yeah,
Rick's just one of those guys that don't talk. You know,
the guy he just don't talk. Rick don't talk because Rick don't have to.
Rick's the kind of guy who will pick you up and drive you anywhere you want, and he never speaks. He's like the best taxi driver you've ever met.
Exactly. Rick is that taxi driver friend that gives you rides for free that everybody has.
Exactly. Because if I'm on the phone with you all night, you're going to know that I'm not on the date.
No, but if you have the date, then call her, cancel it, so that I know that you're serious. And then I'll stay home and talk to you.
I'm not gonna do that to Jen. She has no idea about anything.
No, all she'll know is that you just canceled the date. You're not feeling well. We're not gonna say anything. You know we're not gonna say anything because you've done it with your mom. So we're not gonna say anything. You can call her and cancel. That way I know that you're serious. And that you're serious about not going out with her, and then I'll stay home and I'll talk to you.
I don't know her number.
If Tony has her number, call Tony on three-way. We'll mute ourselves, get the number from Tony, and then call her.
All right, let me hang up and call Tony.
No, just call him on three-way. Call him on three-way.
No, just Tony, you don't know anything about this either.
Wow, all of a sudden... Lauren, who has no qualms about, like, sneaking around and being in three-way calls that people don't know about when it, like, benefits him directly, now all of a sudden has all these moral issues with calling someone on three-way without them knowing what the fuck is going on. Like, that's... Yeah, now that's gonna stop you. Cool. Good for you.
I'm not gonna put a bunch of people through this shit.
Lauren, listen to me, okay? You have a date with someone who knows Tony. Yes or no, right?
Yeah.
So why not call Tony and ask for your date's phone number and just ask for her number? You don't have to say anything about. You don't have to say anything. Just say, hey, what's Jen's phone number?
What's Jen's phone number?
Tony won't give me her number. Tony has to call her.
What?
She doesn't want Tony giving out her number until she knows who it is, and so she knows that for a while.
If you have a date with her, why wouldn't she want you to have her number?
No, I don't know.
Okay, so you have a date with her.
People do all kinds of weird things.
Lauren, listen.
Like you.
You're going on a date with someone tonight, right? And I'm assuming that you have her address so that you can pick her up. Or else you're meeting somewhere mutually, but you'd have to...
That's what we were going to do. We were going to meet somewhere.
Okay, so you're going to meet somewhere, so I'm assuming that you're going to have to call her anyway. She would assume that you would be calling her anyway to say, hey, you know, I'm out front of Walmart, here I am, or whatever. So if that's the case, then you'd need her number anyway. And if you're going on a date with her, she'd have no problem with you having her phone number. You're going on a date.
She didn't give me her number.
My date's one of those girls that just doesn't talk, you know?
My date don't talk.
If Tony has her number...
Tony can call her.
What?
Silent
Tony
Rachel.
Tony is the one that has to call her. But I was just going to meet her someplace.
Well, have Tony give her your number.
No, I get enough people that know my number.
Lauren, you're playing games, okay? Listen to me.
I'm not gonna put anybody on a three-way that way they don't know what the hell is going on.
No, of course not. You're so honorable.
And I cannot understand.
I said I'm not gonna put anybody on a three-way when they don't know what the hell is going on.
They don't need to know what's going on. If you're canceling your date, just say, hey, you know, I'm
you
not
don't have a burn
well.
Phone.
Yeah, just okay, get a burn I'm phone.
Canceling the date. And that's all you have to do.
What, I'm not worth $30 a month?
Oh, God.
Oh, my God.
All of a sudden,
right.
I'm not worth $30 a month?
There's nothing about this going on. If that's what you're doing, then that's what you're doing. And if you were serious,
oh,
yeah,
let me find silent
then
rich.
That would show me that you're serious.
Would you cancel your date with the therapist if Lauren cancels his date?
I'm just going to say this. I don't know who you two are or three are now who have been liking this video, but it was at 69 for a while, and I'm kind of mad at you three.
Yeah. Yeah, that's pretty fucked up, you guys.
And cancel my date.
Well, there you go.
Why'd you make a date to begin with?
No. It's not why. I can say the same to you. It's not about why. It's about if you cancel yours on three-way, I will call and cancel mine on three-way.
Okay, but I can't do it with my phone like that. I can't call Tony and have us be on three-way because my phone doesn't do that. I don't have a smartphone anymore, remember?
Lauren, you have done it before. You can do it. You have done it before. You've been...
I didn't call Emma. Emma called me. So I can't do it unless I call. That's the only way I can do a three-way on the burn phone.
Okay, so while you're on the phone right now...
We've had to do it with Mom before, remember? We've had to do it with Mom before.
Okay, so immediately hang up and call me, and then I'll call Emma. We'll be on three-way, and then you'll immediately call Tony.
Okay.
You have 5 seconds to call me back. Immediately.
All right.
You're 5 seconds from now.
Hang on. All right.
Lauren has a bag phone. Oh my God.
Yes, Lauren.
Why are you doing this?
Oh, here
Why
we go.
Why am I doing what?
Why are you doing this to us?
I actually...
Lauren, what am I doing to us?
Want to shut off my music for this.
You're trying to kill us.
Lauren, you have tried so many times to kill us. I'm just finishing it.
Why are you doing this to us? You're trying to kill us.
Lauren, what am I doing to us?
Why are you doing this?
Why am I doing what?
Why are you doing this to us?
Why?
Lauren, what am I doing to us?
You're trying to kill us.
Lauren, you have tried so many times to kill us. I'm just finishing it.
What a Hallmark moment,
Lauren. You...
Classic.
Lauren, I have my entire family telling me...
Against me.
Lauren, they heard you call me a pathetic bitch, a piece of shit, and a cunt. I don't know how you figure they're going to be cheering you on.
That's a good point.
I can't fucking believe this.
Oh, here it is.
Here
cry.
Are you crying?
I don't fucking believe this.
I can't believe this.
Cheering you on.
I can't fucking believe this. Fucking.
Are you crying?
What's wrong?
No, I'm fucking smiling a big goddamn smile.
Oh,
and you want to fucking cheat on me.
Lauren,
why are you crying?
What's wrong?
I'm in love with you, Ramona. You don't see that? I'm begging you to fucking give me the chance to show you the person I am. You're telling me you're going to cheat on me.
Yeah, yeah.
That's a line somewhere in a romantic comedy or something. That's a line.
Why are you crying?
Yeah, when Lorne met Sally.
Oh my God.
Oh, that's good.
Jesus Christ.
You have always believed in me. Why would you stop? Why would you stop when the therapist comes along?
Why?
Oh,
why?
My God.
So depressing.
Okay, Lauren,
Give me 5 minutes. I gotta take this. I'll call you back. I will call you time. Back in five.
You take a call.
All right.
Hurry back, Ramona.
For days.
Because that's not what he wants.
Well, it was what I wanted at the time.
You gotta take the good with the bad.
He attempted to kiss you.
Gotta take the good with the bad when?
Oh, with Ramona coddling Lorne. Like, there's oh, so sure. many great moments. Ramona, the Ramona saga gave us. Like, you gotta take, like, Ramona placating him a little bit, you know?
Mm-hmm. Well, it's to make sure he stays, you know? Just gotta keep him on exactly. the hook. Yeah.
When he wipes your mouth off, which is something...
Though I have a feeling if everybody was just outwardly cruel to him all the time, he would still keep coming back.
Although, I think... Cybersqueak said the other day something very apt that I thought was such a very good point. She said that Ramona was a great example of somebody who kisses his ass all the time, and he's still a piece of shit to her.
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Right. Like, she treats him better than any human person would for the sake of content.
Still a dick.
Yeah. And he's still shithead.
He's still a dick.
Right.
You know, it's like it's a really great point. And I think Ramona did a very good job of showing that even if you were as nice as possible to Lorne, he would still treat you like shit because he's just that bad of a person, you know?
Yes.
Right. Now, Gorilla Spawn brings up a good point in the chat that perhaps Lorne is Q of QAnon fame. Do you think there's any truth to that? I definitely see that being... I could definitely see him, you know. Could you see Lorne as maybe somebody who's pulling the strings behind the world's governments and running the deep state?
Oh yeah.
I weren't running no deep state conspiracy. Don't know nothing about no Pizzagate.
Oh anyway, my god.
You shouldn't be allowing him to wipe your mouth off when you have a boyfriend anyway. It's just not right. This what? Is not right, Ramona. You cannot tell me it's right because it is not right.
I can tell you it's right because it is right.
It's not right. When you have a boyfriend, you don't let some other guy take you out to dinner and wipe your mouth off.
Again, we have been going on 2 hours of this phone conversation. 2 hours that I've been on the phone with you today. Not one time have you asked about my knee and how my surgery went that was just yesterday.
I wanted to know yesterday.
Not one time. Okay, yeah, you want to know, but you didn't ask. Not because yesterday you were too busy. Yesterday I woke up to text messages saying that if I didn't call you, then we were broken up. That's what I woke up to on the morning of my surgery. Messages saying that if I didn't call you, we were broken up. And then when I got home from my surgery, doped up completely on anesthesia, the messages I got, well, you didn't call me, so it's over. So those are the kind of messages that I got from you. Now, as because, I was saying...
You keep them confusing me with these new guys that you're bringing in.
See, again,
you have to keep doing that.
It goes back to you. It's all about what you want. You've not asked me about...
I don't want to be confused about what you're doing.
I'm not confusing you. I am saying I want to go and see people who are in my state. I'm not being confusing about that.
He's just refusing to believe
it. I want to be in your state with you.
Okay, but Lauren, you're not listening to
me. I don't fucking believe this.
Me.
You haven't been fair to me, so don't tell me you have.
Again, as I was saying, thing one, not asking about the surgery.
It's
thing
you.
Thing two, I am saying to you what I want, but you're not listening. Thing three, it doesn't matter what I want because you want what you want and that's what's going to happen in your world.
Wait, was that a thing three?
You don't want me?
I think there was a thing three.
Lord, I want to be with people who are in
that's a rare thing three, yeah.
Healthy habits, who are showing me that they've got their life together, that they've got their situations handled, that they don't have issues with drinking, that they don't have issues with anger.
I don't have issues with drinking anymore at all. I don't even care to have a beer.
That they're not angry and getting violent, that they have good jobs and that they take care of themselves, that they have a situation where they could take care of me, that they that they're in a situation where they're not, where we can live anywhere in the world that we want to live and where we can travel. that they are mentally healthy, that they do take care of their bodies, and that they're not smoking 3 packs of cigarettes a day. Oh, that's what I want.
You never had a problem with me smoking before.
Lorne doesn't sound great on paper, does he?
Lorne, you're going to do what you're going to do. I'm not going to try and stop you from smoking. I'm not going to try and stop you from smoking. But I don't want to be hacking up a lung. I'm already hacking up a lung from the damn tooth they had down my throat for the surgery you still haven't asked me about. And I don't like that feeling, so I certainly don't want to be inhaling smoke.
Can I ask you about it when you never give me a chance to ask you about it?
When you've been on the phone for 2 hours.
How was the surgery? Because I wanted to know yesterday.
It's a good time to ask.
Okay, well, you didn't ask me yesterday. All you said yesterday was, well, since you didn't call me, it's over.
You never called me, but you found time to call Emma for your surgery.
First of all, she called me, and I answered.
She told me that you called her.
I don't know. She called me. She could have called me, and then I called her immediately back. I don't know. I think that might have been what happened. Who cares? Who gives a shit? I talked to Ella for a few minutes yesterday. Who cares? That's not the point here, Lauren. The point is that you're not...
Why didn't you call me? Let me know that you still want us.
Because, Lauren...
That's not the point
either.
You're
not the focus of yesterday.
No, the focus was supposed to be on your knee.
And that was the focus yesterday.
You had to put that therapist there. That's right.
That was the focus yesterday. And yes,
You were flirting with him on the phone. You didn't meet on the phone.
As I was saying, that was the focus yesterday, and I am glad that I had someone there who literally could pick me up and put me in the wheelchair and pick me up and put me in the car.
Sounds pretty impressive.
Yeah.
I'm kind of into this therapist.
The nurses, or your brother, or the 10 friends that you had.
The nurses could not come home with me. That is not the point. The point is that you're not listening to what I'm saying to you, that I've been saying for 2 hours, and yesterday.
You're still not listening to anything.
Me, personally, if I had a loved one, I would just be happy that somebody was there for them when I could not be. You know?
Oh, sure. But yeah, like, well, that's what a normal person does.
Exactly.
Lorne, and I hate that so much about him. Like, you know, it's so awful. It's ridiculous, and I've always hated that about him. Like, you know, how dare someone be there for you when you needed them?
That isn't me.
That's cheating on me,
right?
That a person was there to support you when I could not physically be there to help you, you know?
Bet you're going to suck him off, too. Take down his britches and start sucking away.
I said to you.
But that wasn't a tube down your throat.
Then, Lauren, go be with somebody.
That weren't no ventilator tube.
Lauren, then, Lauren, if I'm not listening, go be with someone who will be with you.
Yes, I want to be with you. And I want to show you the real person I am, but you don't know why, because you constantly put a threat there. Why do you need to constantly put a threat there with
us? This is the real person you are.
I am not putting a threat.
This is everything you
want. I am trying to have a life down here. You need to go try to have a life up there.
Friends, you make me understand how this therapy is going to be a friend when you're sending messages to Emma about his moist lips, taking a picture of his butt and sending the picture of his butt to your mom. How do you really think that's going to be construed?
So exasperated with that one. Take a picture of his butt and send a picture of his butt to his mom.
That's my bot.
Taking a picture of his butt and sending the picture of his butt to your mom. How do you really think that's going to be construed?
Then, Lord, if it's going to be construed bad, then go find someone who will not do those things.
Do you want me?
Well, you're not here. You don't have the things that I'm wanting from someone. In a relationship, you're not willing to do those things. You don't have those things.
What, money?
I have my own.
You all of a sudden turn into a money girl?
All of a sudden, you're a money girl.
First of all, I have my own money. That's thing one. Thing two.
That's important that he has that Escalade.
Couldn't even get to thing two that time.
As I was saying, let's clear up something. Because I don't like to hear any guy talk about women as, oh, you're all about money? You just want him for his money? More, and that's what I've said since day one. Hang on 1 second.
I'll have to cancel this date.
Oh, my God.
I deserve to give you the 3 months, and you deserve to get the 3 months from me.
Lord, I deserve to have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 decades of a good relationship, and I don't think it would come from you, because you're so hung up on 3 months instead of 3 years, 3 decades. 3 centuries. You're not hung up on being a good man permanently. You're hung up on showing me.
I'm hung up on being a good man to you permanently.
Okay.
You're not going to be able to see what kind of man I am until you meet me in person.
Oh, my God.
Lauren, what I have seen over the phone is not something I want.
What if it's true? What if, like, if someone went there in person and he's the nicest guy in the world, like he's a completely different guy. And then they get there and there's like all these papers on the floor that exonerate him and like all this bad stuff about Xavier Von Erk's past criminal history that no one knew about.
I want it all to be true. I give credit to Lorne where credit's due. I think he would be a great guy for a fucking week. And then after that, the real Lorne would come back, and that would be what they experienced the entire time, you know?
Once he got comfortable.
Like, exactly what happened with Ember and them who came and visited him. Like, he was so funny and, you know, laughing his ass off and friendly and stuff like that. But I think if they would have stayed for a little while longer, they would have gotten to see the real Lorne in person, you know?
Yeah, yeah. Absolutely. And it would not be pleasant.
Exactly.
You don't want a guy having to be pissed off. Show me that I'm important enough to meet.
As I was saying,
what you've been showing me is that you're listening to everything the therapist says about you, and that guy doesn't even have any ethical values of his own. Otherwise, he wouldn't be getting personal with his clients. You would have saw the look on Allie's face when I told her how personal the therapist got with you.
Okay, that's great. That's great that your therapist, who I will never meet, has an opinion on someone.
You should have seen the look on my therapist's face.
Who she'll never meet. That's great that your therapist has an opinion on someone she's never even talked to. That's
somebody that's in her same profession.
Lauren, if that is the case, and if all of these things bother you, I am telling you, go on your date, go find someone who won't.
I'm not going on my date, and I want you to cancel yours.
As I was saying, go find someone who will not do these things if they bother you.
What bothers me is you not telling them no.
Lauren, I don't want to tell them no anymore. That is not what I want to do. What I want to do is be young and be free and be happy and not worry about the fact that I am constantly getting abused because I have friends, or abused because I talk to my grandmother, or abused because I want to watch a Lifetime movie. I just want to enjoy my life.
Enjoy it with me. 100%. Oh my like you God. Used to do.
Only
as
me.
You like to say, you've been with me for 9 months. And in those
enjoy
9 months,
enjoy it with me.
The only enjoyment I got were a few laughs here and there and abuse.
Like he's acting as if just adding him to your life will not diminish your enjoyment. Like you can just add him and keep the same amount of joy you had, as if he isn't a black hole that sucks in everything good around him.
Exactly. Like I love when he tries to do the if you keep fucking up, then I'm not going to call you again. It's like, oh, no, don't not call me.
Oh, my God, please, no.
I'll never hear from you again. I won't have my phone ringing 12 hours a day. How horrifying.
That's his only threat. That's all he's got.
Yeah.
Friday and Saturday.
So you're going to quit. You're going to quit on me. When you're afraid that I'm right, that I'm a changed person, that I know that I can go 3 months and I can go 3 decades. What do I think I could go first?
You can go 3 decades?
That's what your therapist, so-called therapist, says. I'm a good person and you know it.
Lauren, I don't know it because I've not seen any corroboration.
You give me these 3 months to show you, and we meet, and then you tell me that I'm not a good person.
Lauren, I have seen you at what you consider your best, and I have seen you not at your worst. I've seen you at pretty bad, but not at your worst, because we're not face-to-face to where I could see you at your worst.
The only thing you would, if we were face-to-face and I got frustrated, the only thing you would see would be frustration in my face.
Oh,
yeah,
no.
Hi,
oh, God. Am I being threatened? Yeah, it does sound. That sounds on brand. Hello, Malena. Hello, Malena. Down under. Wallaby. Is that what you wanted? Shrimp on the barbecue, huh? Is this how you wanted me to say hello to you?
She's the kangaroo lady.
Kangaroo lady?
I don't
She's the rude lady.
Unless they attack someone that I love physically, then I don't even like hitting anyone.
Lauren, I know you've hit your dogs before, so I mean,
just spank them on the ass.
No.
I don't even spank them now because of you.
Okay, how do you spank someone by not hitting them? What is this? You hit your dog. I spank them. Spank is not a euphemism for hit. It just means you repeatedly hit them.
I don't even. I tap them on the ass. I don't even do that anymore.
You did not tap
them
on the ass
when you're talking about
the ass. Right.
I hit them on the ass, but I don't hit them hard.
Okay,
and
Lauren.
I don't do it anymore anyway. Because of you.
Okay, Lauren, you're trying to find euphemisms. It's like saying,
You're trying to make me look bad. You're doing exactly what Barry's trying to do. Make me look bad.
Lauren, you're actually.
Why are you doing that?
Lauren, listen to me. I have not hundreds, but tens of people in my life dearly who have loved me all my life, who have loved me most of my life, or who have come into my life and not asked for anything from me, but just wanted to give. I have a bunch of people like that in my life, people who I respect and care about deeply.
All I want to do is give you the real me.
As I was saying. And all of these people now have found out about you, and not one of them is supportive of it. All of them are showing me reasons why I need to run. Things that
everyone
I was thinking
hates
about
you, Lauren.
Before, but now it's like, well, it's kind of difficult to ignore it, because whereas I could put things out of my mind
Lauren
before and just go on, now I'm confronted with the fact that people know.
I'm sorry, what? What are they saying about me right now?
Shins Koala says you have very moist lips.
Yeah, no, that's a good point. That's a really good point. Thank you, Shin. I was hoping someone would be monitoring the moisture on my lips, and I'm glad someone stepped up to the plate.
Those glistening lips.
Glistening.
These people, because think about it, these people.
Because I
don't
stay
want
so goddamn hydrated.
They don't want me. They don't want me to miss out. You know, especially my parents. My parents don't want me to miss out on a good relationship. My parents don't want that at all. My brothers don't want me to miss out on a good relationship. They all want me to be happy.
All I want is for you to be happy too. But I want to show you that I can make you happy.
Lauren, please let me finish. These people do not want harm for me. They want me to be happy. If I was with a, I don't know, a guy who cleaned bathroom toilets for a living, but he was a good guy, and they saw how he respected me, and they saw him treat me well, and they knew that he wanted to care about me and care for me, they would be happy. It's not about the money. I mean, money's nice. I have money. It's nice. It's nice to have. At the end of the day, it's a security blanket, and it feels good to go to sleep knowing that you have money in your account. That's a
great
feeling.
It's fine. I'm rich.
But it's not
nice.
About the money. Because at the end of the day, I don't want to lay in bed and cuddle up with my money. And because first of all, I'm a germaphobe, and that would be gross. But second of all, that's not what I want to do at the end of the day. So what I'm saying to you is that these people who are in my life, people who I trust, people who I care about, people who care about me, people who I know for a fact don't want any harm to me. And not one of them is saying Lauren is a good guy. In fact, all of them are saying the exact opposite. All of them
are working with me.
Is that they're not even like, I mean, everybody's concerned about my surgery, but more so than my surgery, more so than me going under anesthesia. When you go under anesthesia, they ask if you have a living will because you might die under anesthesia. They're not thinking about that as much as they're thinking about this thing that I'm doing with you. And
Lauren's like, hold on. Do I need one of those? What's a living what?
That is where everybody's concern is. Although they, don't get me wrong, they did good because everyone came to the hospital and was very concerned. But now they're back.
The difference is they don't know me and you do. You've seen the frustrations that I've had to deal with that I've gotten through because of you.
Of course.
Lauren, let me tell you.
You were there to help me through them. You're the one that got me to this point where I know I can go these 3 months and I know I can go 3 decades. I know I can go 3 centuries treating you good. Treating you like I want to treat you. Treat you like you deserve to be treated.
Lauren,
I need these 3 months to show you that.
Lauren, my family does not need
David.
To quote mill you.
About the dog
my family does not need to see
that.
You. My family does not need to know.
Sorry, say that again.
I said, I'm good, David. Thank you for caring about the doggos. I very much appreciate that.
Yes, yes. Very, very concerned citizen. That David Kedrick. He's the one who came on and talked about Lauren's dogs, like people calling the animal control, right? Or animal protective, right?
Yeah, and
yes,
you know,
yes,
I very
yes.
much appreciate that.
Yeah, that was really helpful. Because I'm sure people were calling quite a bit. Hopefully that's tapered off now.
Know your name, your birth date, your address, anything like that, to know that if somebody calls someone who is supposed to be their girlfriend a bitch, a cunt, a pathetic bitch, that they don't want them to be around that person. If I heard somebody call, if I had a daughter and I heard somebody call her that, I don't care if it was the freaking president. If I heard somebody call my daughter a cunt, I would want them gone.
Oh yes, I remember David Kedrick. I said a little brain fart.
Fast. Because she doesn't deserve that. Because she doesn't deserve to be dealing with being called those names. And for the very first time in my life,
I don't want to call you names.
Okay,
I want to be able to love you like you deserve to be loved.
Okay, but see, Lauren, you might say that you want that, but that's not what you've done. And here's the thing: I'm not holding.
That's what I'm going to do.
Lauren, I'm not holding.
What's the difference? I told you before when Mom said that it woke me up to what the hell I was doing.
Lauren.
All because I was upset and frustrated about everybody else that's treating you wrong. And that woke my ass up.
Hey, Lauren, it's nice that you decided to get woken up after 9 months, as you like to say. But the fact of the matter is,
it's more nice to see you quitting on me after 9 months.
Lauren.
I'm a therapist.
Lauren, I should quit on you after 2 months. After the very first time you did that. There shouldn't have been a 9 months.
No, because we should have met a long, long time ago.
No, we shouldn't have.
Yeah, so you could actually see me in person, so I could see you in person. Then we wouldn't have this hanging over our head that we've never met.
He's really not listening to me. He's really, truly not listening to me.
You're not listening to me. Anything I say, you're making it null and void.
To go, and I need to meet someone. Now, here's the thing. The very beginnings of the Lauren and Ramona saga, the things that you were doing was repeatedly texting me and getting drunk. At that point, you hadn't started calling me names. I'll give you credit. You didn't start calling me names until about month three. So from month one or zero, month zero to month three,
Right, like I love when she acknowledges that, like the meta story, like at the very beginning of the Ramona story arc, Lorne,
You didn't call me names. And I'll give you credit for that, that you didn't call me a bitch until you had known me for 3 months. So you would get angry and jealous. Am I going to be able to talk or am I going to just have to hang up and just go?
And just go to a therapist?
Wherever I want to. Now, as I was saying, in the beginning, you would message me repeatedly. I'd tell you, Lauren, I just want to watch Lifetime movies. It's Friday. I was by myself, laying in my on my couch with my tablet, watching Lifetime movies and eating junk food. That is how I sometimes prefer to spend a Friday. And that's what I would do. If I said I was doing that, that's what I was doing every single time. I got accused of doing, of going out with people, of doing this, of doing that. Anything else, anything in the world that I could be accused of, I was accused of. I would wake up with messages. I would go to sleep. I would wake up with a barrage of messages. I went to New York. And what happened when I went to New York? On my way to New York, you sent me a penis picture, a picture of your penis and your face in the picture. And after that, you asked me 100 questions about your penis. Is it enough for me? Is it satisfying? Blah, blah, blah. And I was with my girlfriend, all girlfriends. And I was not at my phone. In fact, much of the night I had left my phone in the car. And what happened? The next morning, I got woken up to a bunch of text messages about how, because I didn't answer any questions about your penis, that meant that I was cheating on you with someone who I met in a club in New York. That's what I dealt with in the beginning. Month 3 through, let's say, 6 was a Lauren who, if I didn't spend, 8 hours on the phone with him, 6 hours on the phone with him, 4 hours on the phone with him every single solitary day, I was accused of not making time, of cheating, of anything that you wanted to think of. And that's when you started calling me names. That's when I was called a bitch. That's when I was called a cunt. That's when I was called a piece of shit, a pathetic loser. That's one thing that you called me before. All sorts of things that I wouldn't even call you, but that you called me. And
you put up with a therapist calling you there.
As I was saying. And you're exploding, screaming, cursing constantly at me. Then months 6 through 9... Well, part of that time I injured my knee. I could count, and I was laid up with a knee injury. Now, here's the thing. When I was with the knee injury, it was a lot of physical therapy, a lot of doctor's appointments. I mean, pretty much almost every single day, there was something going on with my knee, whether it was a physical therapy appointment or doctor's appointment, or the case may be. Sometimes I'd have to, you know, sometimes I'd be in the wheelchair. Bro was wheeling me around all the time. All sorts of different things that meant that I didn't have full mobility as I did before. So what did I do during that time? Sometimes I read, sometimes I talked on the phone with Nana and with other friends. I tried to catch up on things around the house and certain administrative type tasks, making calls that I needed to do, those types of things. What did Lauren do? Lauren didn't ask, I'm really sorry about your knees, what's going on? Lauren was upset because Lauren wasn't getting attention all the time like he used to. Because now I have a knee injury, and I'm sleeping a lot more. My sleep schedule's messed up. All sorts of things. The main theme is that Lauren didn't get what Lauren wanted, and Lauren found another reason to explode. So now that we're going into month 10, now Lauren proclaims that he's a changed man and all this stuff is new and he's going to be great and he's going to be super. I just have to tell all the guys in my life who have shown me, in some cases for years, that they are fit to be a healthy, good partner. I just have to tell them that, hey, you know, bye-bye. Don't want anything to do with you. Don't hit on me anymore. I'm going to date this guy in Maine who has now decided almost a year into knowing him that he's going to be a good person. Are you joking?
There's a lot of things that we've gone through. There's a lot of different things that have happened. Except the saying about
me. You did let her talk for a good
different
while.
Things have
yeah, she kind of let him, or yeah, he let her get on a little bit of a ramble.
Never used to have anybody be honest with
me.
Bit of a rare moment, you know?
Yeah, kind of.
Somebody that I hadn't met yet.
Got to think
probably
five.
Wasn't listening.
Right.
That was a huge thing. But if you remember back,
months 1 to 3.
We loved spending time together.
The first 10 issues.
We loved it a lot. That's the person that I am. I'm with you. I'm sorry, but I love spending time with you. And I love having a good time with you. I love having fun. I love being a good person. It's not my fault when other people come into the picture that I get threatened by. But all I need to hear is, please leave me. I told them, no, leave me alone. I have a boyfriend. That's when I started getting confused. I just don't need the threats. All I've ever asked from you, just tell the threats to leave you alone. I know you're honest to me. Well, this therapist came along and you were flirting with him on the phone, with me on the phone, that fucked me up. I can't tell you that it didn't fuck me up. It fucked me up. I never expected that to happen. And the stuff that Emma said that you said. I never expected that. Like, in the dinner, I couldn't believe that he asked you out to dinner. I couldn't believe that you were contemplating it.
Well, I'm going out tonight, and you can do whatever you want. You have a date set up. Go on it. Do not stand her up.
I'm not going on it. I want you to cancel a date from Sarah.
I'm not going to cancel tonight. I'm not.
Why won't you cancel tonight?
What?
Why won't you cancel tonight?
Because I want to go.
You want to know what?
Because I want to go.
You want to go spend time with another guy?
Lauren, I want to go spend time with a guy who's respectful, who's kind, and who
spend time with me. Something you haven't done for 2 months.
Lauren, I have talked to you on the phone.
Why are you killing us?
Lauren, I have talked to you on the phone for hours and hours.
Oh my God.
How long?
Lauren, I have talked to you on the phone for hours and hours and hours.
How long did you talk to the therapist today? How long have you been on? Did you talk to him on the phone?
Maybe 15, 20 minutes. I have talked
15,
to you.
20 minutes. You gave him time and you couldn't give me time.
Lauren, I'm on the phone with you right now. But here's the thing, Lauren. If somebody is not giving
how
you
much time,
why are
them?
You trying to force them
yeah,
to
this
be
already
with
is
you?
So much time.
Yeah.
It's already been 45 fucking most. Minutes. Right.
She's given him plenty of time to behave like a good person, and right. He's not done it, right. You know?
9 fucking months. Yeah, exactly.
Why am I trying to force you? I shouldn't have to be trying to force you. You're the one who started going out with these fucking guys.
You're supposed to be obedient.
What's, yeah, come on. You're supposed to be beneath me. Don't you understand that, Ramona? Yeah. What's going on, DJ Payne 1? Good to see you.
Maybe that's
the one that cheated, not me. I didn't invite this guy into my life. I only have a girl into my life.
Well, maybe
now
that's,
we're together.
Well, maybe that's a sign that we're not right
it's
for
a sign
each other.
That you cheat?
Well, maybe that's a sign.
Is that a sign that you cheat?
First of all,
is
I've
that
never
a sign that you
on
cheat?
Anybody who I've ever
You went out to dinner. Do a fucking dinner date with this guy. This same guy that you're saying you can't go out to a date with tonight over to his fucking house.
Ooh.
Are you not hearing yourself?
So upset.
This same
so upset.
Guy who went on a...
Oh, my God.
Same guy that you're saying you can't go out to a date with tonight over to his fucking house. Are you not hearing yourself?
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
The same
so
girl
sad.
You went on a dinner date
Reverse
with.
That, Lord. Reverse
when
that.
When we were together, you cheated on me. And you want to see how bad of a person I am?
Were
what
they
do
on
you
break
even possibly
this?
Think about going on a
they...
date with somebody that's supposed to be professional?
Yeah, this is whenever they were on a break.
This is when they
and,
were on
like,
a break.
They were seeing other people, right?
Right, right. But it was like Ramona was starting to see the therapist, but Lauren definitely wasn't seeing anybody else. So he fabricated this date to make her jealous, I guess. And now she's still going on her date. And he's like, no. We're going to call them both off and we're back together. So,
yeah,
you know, classic. Yeah, right. Failed miserably.
The ethic value that he's supposed to have in his profession and gets personal with a client. And are you texting him right now? How much time are you giving this guy?
More.
You sure what the fucking problem is, but you don't want to admit it. You just want to blame everything on me. It's my fault that you had to see that therapist. It's my fault that therapist asked you out to dinner. It's my fault that you went on the dinner date with him. It's my fault because you want to go hang out with him at his fucking house tonight alone so that he can... put his fucking lips on yours?
Excuse me?
Are you fucking kidding me?
His fucking lips on yours?
It's probably my fault that you saw the doctor naked. It's my fault that the doctor saw you naked.
Ah, the doctor.
Oh, isn't
it what?
Right? I never said it was your fault.
Hold on. We can't go back to the doctor now, right? This can't be where we go back to the doctor.
It's right square one. Right
it
back.
Seems like we're back to the doctor.
At his fucking house tonight, alone, so that he can put his fucking lips on yours.
Oh, so like he was like he's like trembling, like he's about to cry.
He's upset.
Are you kidding
me? His lips on yours.
It's probably my fault that you saw the doctor naked. It's my fault that the doctor saw you naked.
Oh my God.
Oh, isn't that Ramona?
I never once said it was your fault that the doctor and I saw each other naked.
You cheated on me.
I didn't cheat on you.
You did too.
You okay, then, Lauren, if I cheated
you
on
you,
you
were going to bring your brother. You lied to me.
Lauren, if
you
I cheated...
You were going to bring your brother. You did it.
Lauren, first of all, if I cheated on you, then leave. Don't be with the cheater. If you think I cheated on you, then leave.
How can you say you didn't? You lied to me, too. You told me you were going to bring it.
Thanks, Just a Giant Rat. Thanks for coming by.
Brother, you did.
Okay, so Lauren.
You didn't tell me about it.
Okay, so
how
Lauren,
are you so perfect?
So I'm a cheater and I'm a liar. Then leave the cheating liar.
Yeah, pretty much.
Do you want me or do you want this fucking therapist?
Sounds reasonable.
Lauren, leave.
Just tell me an answer.
Do you think if
well, apparently
if,
I must want the therapist because if I'm going out on a quote
cheated,
date with him and quote
would he still be with her?
If you call it a date, he asked you out to dinner over to his house.
I do. I think it would be like maybe like the just... yeah, the 10th time cheating, maybe he would consider leaving. Like it would not be the first time he caught them cheating. No.
And she would hear it. Over and like every
oh,
day.
Every time
what
that she every
did.
Time there was an argument, every time there was like a disagreement, be like, well, maybe why don't you go out and fuck another guy then?
Well,
why don't you
like,
go back
I
out? Why don't you go back out there and suck on someone else's cock then, huh? And takes like a
thing,
just downs an entire beer.
I think that's the thing, but I also think he would kind of like it because then he would have something to lord over her. He would have
yes.
be like he could guilt her into stuff because she did some previous transgression. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Oh,
right,
yeah.
Exactly.
So, yeah, he wouldn't leave her.
He's like the best at holding grudges. Yeah, he'll do it forever.
Yeah.
Lauren, then if I'm doing
why
that...
you were on the phone, why you had a boyfriend? That's
Lauren,
respectable. That's
I'm...
real respectable.
Okay, as I was saying, if I'm doing all these things... then leave. Go be with Jenny. Go be with Jenny.
No.
And go on
your date. Cancel your date, too.
I'm not canceling on anybody.
I want you to cancel. You never should have even set it up.
And I'm
never
saying to
you,
but I'm not. I'm saying go out with her and enjoy yourself.
I'm not in this. You plan on kissing this guy tonight?
No, because I don't kiss on second dates either.
He's going to sit next to you. What you going to do? You don't even know this fucking guy.
Lauren, go out. I could say the same thing. You don't even know this fucking girl. You don't even know her. I could say the same thing, but instead I'm saying go out. And
I'm not going over her house.
Yeah, but she's getting in the car with you.
You already did that with the therapist.
Lauren.
You're supposed to be riding with your brother.
Lauren, go out. Do not stand her up.
Fine. You go to the therapist's office. We're not breaking up. We're not breaking up. We deserve these 3 months. But I know that I can do it. I just don't know that you can't say no to these other guys. But for 3 months, my head's going to be a mess until you tell me that you can go through, you know, 3 months without fucking saying yes to dates with guys.
Can you go 3 months without saying yes to dates with other guys? Break up with her, Lauren?
Your best.
Go out with her.
When is the sex with other guys going to stop?
When is it going to stop?
As I was saying, go stop out with fucking her and people. Enjoy yourself.
And you go to the therapist's house.
Yes.
You have dinner. Make goddamn sure he does not kiss you. You and I are not broken up. We're giving this a fair shot.
Make goddamn sure he does not kiss you.
Like we had in the beginning. So we can actually see what each other is really like. 100% you and me. Is that a deal?
We'll see what happens, Lauren. I'm gonna hop off of here and go get ready.
You don't need to dress up in something sexy either.
this conversation.
Anything sexy. I'm having jeans and a t-shirt on.
I can dress myself, you know.
But you don't need to do anything to turn them on.
If he chooses to get turned on by what I wear, then that's on him.
Wear fat lady clothes.
Wear fat lady clothes?
Thanks, yeah. Lauren.
What the hell does that even mean?
I don't know.
Or something real ugly. Weird.
I'm a prick.
So now you're telling me how to dress?
I'm trying to be fucking funny here.
Hee.
Lauren, go have fun, okay?
You just laugh at that shit.
Well, I mean, you're telling me how to dress and telling me to wear fat lady.
I was trying to make a joke, but, you don't remember about the diaper thing. That was a fucking joke. You laughed at it when I said it.
It
was a joke. I don't know why you twist that around.
I didn't. We both know you used to get turned on by the thought of me and my diaper. We haven't talked about me and my diaper.
I didn't get turned on by it.
You said you wanted to have sex with me while I wore it.
No, I did not.
Yes, you
did. I said I was going to change your diaper for you. I was trying to be funny about saying that.
You're
old enough to change your own diaper.
You said that you wanted
old enough.
You talked about changing my diaper and then having sex. And then you talked about having sex through my diaper.
No, I did not.
Yes, you did, Lauren.
I didn't say about anything about having sex through your diaper.
Lauren, you did.
Like hell I did. I know goddamn well I didn't say that.
I'll bet he did.
Then what are you saying that you said? Because I remember every time I come home from work, you say, well, pin your diaper for me.
I was trying to be funny.
LOL.
And you laughed then.
I laughed at that.
Laugh out loud.
What I said before was, I'll change your diaper, and then we can have sex. I take your diaper off and I clean you up and then we have sex. That's what I was saying. I wasn't saying put another diaper on you and we have sex through your diaper.
I love how he introduces fetishes like that.
Well, you know what I meant.
It's difficult.
Like it's a little joke.
Wouldn't it, be,
Yeah, like, wouldn't it be funny if you did this thing, if you dressed a certain way?
Yeah. How silly would it be if you wore a diaper, LMAO?
Oh, how funny would it be if you dressed up like a cat girl from anime, you know, like...
I would laugh so hard.
Yeah, exactly. It's so bad.
Right, TJ Payne. If you fart around me, I'm gonna pull your ass down. I'll put my dick in your ass.
Oh my god.
It's so gross.
Instead of using your hands on my cock, maybe try your feet.
Try your feet? Oh, I don't know.
Wait, I don't know.
I definitely laugh.
That would be fucking funny.
So fucking funny you did that shit.
Possible, but you know what I meant.
That's what I was trying to think of. It would be impossible to do.
But you know what I mean? Like, have my diaper as a part of our sex life. That's what you were saying.
No, the other thing I was saying was I would change the diaper, I would take the diaper off, and I would clean you up, and then we could have sex. That's what I was saying.
That was Austin Jones, Amanda. It was.
Nobody else knew anything about you wearing a diaper. I don't know why you would even tell Emma that. Don't tell her personal shit like that.
I didn't tell her in a douchebaggy kind of way. I told her that you thought that it was... What did I tell her?
Something awful.
I think you told her that I thought it was sexy or something like that.
Hold on a second. And I told her that in a, like, you know, like, I just, you know, nobody else, I would imagine, would... think that I was basically that, you know, I told her it factually, I told her matter of fact that nobody else knows that I wear a diaper. Nobody else except bro. Yeah. And you know,
that's why my mouth dropped when Emma said that.
Well, I told her that nobody else here meaning where I am, you know, friends and family and stuff, nobody else knows that I wear one, and I told you, and I had said it as, not only does he know, but he also finds it sexy that I wear a diaper.
I find that
like she's proud.
Funny as hell that I do sexy. I think it's just funny because it's special to me because you shared something really secretive with me, and I love that. And I haven't told anybody. That's why I couldn't believe that Emma knew it. But she turned it around.
Wait. I remember something else that you said. You asked me when I can't remember if you, I can't remember which version of this you said, but you'll remember when you said, when I come up, when I come to meet you, can I wear only my diaper and a coat over it? When I come to meet you,
I remember saying that. I remember saying, telling you to wear a diaper on the plane if it makes you comfortable.
Yeah, and you said, and just wear a coat over it. You knew I was going to wear it on the plane. I'm like, I bought him.
Maybe I did say that because it would have been fucking hilarious.
Because you wanted me to, he's a goofy. You wanted me to wear just my diaper and a coat, and I'd show up in just my diaper and a coat.
That would have made me laugh my ass off if you really did.
LOL.
That would have been so fucking hilarious. I didn't believe that you would do it anyway, but it would have been, that would be fucking hilarious.
Can you spank me while I wear my diaper and then take it off and have sex with me?
He's a sexy baby.
I wanted to spank you anyway in a nice way.
Well, I didn't mean you.
I don't remember anything with the diaper.
Roscoe spanked me. I just meant you gently spanked me while I was wearing my diaper.
I'd much rather have you diaper off than I would on when I spank you.
Oh, God, yes.
Wait, what?
Here it is. Here we go.
I'd rather have you have a heavy diaper off than I would on.
Why?
When I spank you. Oh, my hand could actually touch your sexy ass.
No, I'll show up in
God
my diaper, having a pacifier and just like a
horrible.
Jesus.
This is horrible.
I just thought about that, too. And it just popped in my mind, if you showed up in your diaper, I'd have a pacifier there for you.
Oh, my
That's fucking funny shit. Maybe one of them with plastic key ring things.
Mm-hmm. What else?
And I'll run around in my diaper with a pacifier in my mouth.
Oh, that'd be fucking hilarious. I don't know, I really wouldn't want to do that, so it'd also be extremely embarrassing.
You know what would be really funny, Lorne Identity?
Well, no one else would see.
Please,
if you
please.
Just, like, what would be really funny? In, like, a schoolgirl outfit.
Sure.
If you just, like, did a stream in a school. That would be so fucking funny.
Would that make you laugh? Would that make you laugh really hard?
it's hilarious. If you just did a stream in a schoolgirl outfit, that would just... It would be the funniest thing ever, you know?
What a fun whimsical time that would be.
Oh, excellent, you know?
Looks like you can rock a little pigtails there.
Oh, almost certainly.
You could do beard pigtails.
Beard tails.
That's what I was thinking, when you get off the plane, and you have pacifier and a plastic set of key rings.
Oh, okay, those key rings.
Yeah. That would be fucking... hilarious, but extremely embarrassing.
Well, I think that's a way to get kicked out of the airport.
Yeah, that would be a really good way to get kicked out of the airport and probably arrested.
Fine, Poop Frog, I won't.
Because they'd probably wonder what was inside of the diaper.
But you know what? How Emma turned it around was that she said,
you know what would be really funny?
What do you think would be funny?
That was
what, and this is, I totally agree. Milena said this, and right. I think it would just be a gas if you dress up as a genie and stream.
Mm.
Oh, yes.
Now that would be funny. That would make that would make people laugh so hard.
That would be so great.
When you started having different second thoughts about me. And thinking that, you know, there's something wrong because he likes me wearing a diaper.
No!
It'd be because of my charge. And she turned it around.
What did it do with your charge?
That's something to do with it, though.
I didn't think that you being attracted to me wearing my diaper would be any kind of, I didn't think you being attracted to me while I wore a diaper was anything that would associate with your charge. Not at all. I don't know if she heard me wrong, but I mean, what I was saying.
Is anything else happening in here?
You would judge me thinking that I got...
Okay. I'm done with this one. It was just going to be a diaper. If it's just going to be a diaper vortex, I think I'm good.
It's
on the diaper vortex.
Circling. It's not going
anywhere. Yeah. There's like 10 minutes left. It's not worth it. Let me see. Like, I got this silent Rick call here. We're going to play, you know, stream takedown roulette for a little bit and just get to, I know it's after the middle. I just got to, skip around and find it. It's when Tiffany's talking to him. I feel like I told somebody where it was at one point, but now I forget.
God, I love Tiffany in this call where she's she's gonna call the cops on him. It's so good. It's like everything it's so you want to say, she always says it. You know.
Right, let's see if I can find.
Well, if I can roll, you see, I've never had it, but Roy didn't. Boy seemed to like it.
What are you
I thought
doing?
It was gross.
Apologize. Is he on his way over?
There we go.
No.
Start recording now. Because he's not done making noises.
I have no control over that.
Debbie,
I have no idea.
I am sorry.
I almost had a Beatles moment there. That was almost catastrophic.
Another one against moms that I made you, but it's my mom.
Lauren, then call your mom. Do something. You said that you called your brother. Is he on his way over there? Or was that another lie, too?
No. That was a lie because I can't call my brother. I can't call anybody else when I'm on the phone with anybody with somebody else.
Well, you can.
Because I have a cheap ass phone.
Right. So hang up and call your brother if that's what you're concerned about. Or just let him sleep it off and deal with it tomorrow. There was no.
Will you help me deal with tomorrow?
To do that.
Will you and Wendy help me deal with tomorrow?
Listen to me right now.
Shut up.
What you did was absolutely fucked up. You lied more than once. Because you knew that you were going to get
I'm sorry
car,
for lying, okay?
Drive.
Oh,
don't
no.
Don't apologize.
It's my mom, Debbie.
He's driving at this point,
down
right?
There doing that. It's my mom.
Is he? Yeah, he's driving. Well, I guess that's why. I don't know if she confronts him while he's driving
you
or before.
What are you doing?
But like he's, I think it's while he's driving when he says like, oh yeah, my friend Rick's driving.
You
he don't
should
talk.
Not be doing what you're doing.
I think it's around
what
here.
What do you think that would do to her if you did crash into a tree? If you killed someone else?
They're saying in the chat that this
you
is like
know
after
better.
He got caught.
This is after he got caught? Okay. So it might be earlier. Let's just try.
Clark earlier played a call where it had Beatles in it, you know, and
yeah.
Like it's always fear. So like
yeah.
I do get that.
Whoop. Okay, skip that.
What are you doing?
Huh, nope.
All right, let's go.
All right.
Let's try this. I'm just gonna sit here and stare at the stare at the screen.
Baby?
Hello?
Tomorrow? Can you hear me, baby?
Baby.
Oh, yeah, now I
can. Baby, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Tomorrow? The motherfucker is gonna get a rude goddamn awakening.
Oh no, wrathful Lord!
Push record.
Oh, no.
I want you to record him.
Okay.
Whew.
Tiffany is amazing, Amanda.
Awakening. Yeah,
that cannot
seriously.
Be understated.
I want him to hear this. I want him to hear this shit tomorrow.
Hello. I don't know how to record. Tell me. What?
Emma, help! Emma.
What? I'm at the movie theater.
Wait, we need to record. We need to record because we need to record Roy.
All right. Winnie,
she's so
password
disappointed.
Is 10:15. What do I do with that? You open up the call assistant and type it in. 10:13. Okay, bye.
Don't say bye to her like that. Two of you are running lost.
Don't say bottle I
this call is being recorded.
Yeah. Fucking smart.
Okay, just want to let you know this call is being recorded.
Alright.
Oh my god. What is this noise?
Debbie
said it on there.
Yeah, she's in the kitchen.
Okay.
You didn't hear
God
nothing.
Damn it.
Okay, here we go. It's got to be, so it's got to be like, maybe like 16 minutes in.
I think this is like after she's realized that he is full of shit and she's starting to like, God damn it.
I'm so close.
Because you're lying.
That's just the way that
Reagan.
That's the way
that
Reagan
is. Okay. Here it is. Okay. So it's like right at the end of a song, which is so annoying. All right. So it's 17 minutes exactly in. Okay. There we go. Let's try that.
Well, like.
Hi, that.
My friend Rick just.
Okay. So he says it at the end of a song.
Bring me over to mom's.
He says, my friend Rick is going to take me over to mom's while the Beatles play in the background. And that's as much of that as we're going to play there. But the song will end and then he will talk more about it. Da, 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 da.
I want to hear him say hi.
He's like,
there we go.
He's not saying hi.
I don't believe
you. Oh, okay. Is that because you're driving?
No.
Yeah.
Rick won't talk to anybody.
Oh, bullshit. You're a fucking liar.
Oh my god.
No, no.
That's good. That's pretty good. That was worth it.
I don't know if you're gonna see that, Debbie.
I'm gonna go back to 1725 again and hear that from the beginning. Okay.
Because you're lying.
Well, my friend Rick.
Beatles, Beatles, Beatles are singing and dancing and dancing and they're fading out and Rick is driving and the Beatles are here, but you cannot hear them.
Right,
there we go, there we go.
Have your friend say hi. I want to hear him say hi.
He's not saying hi.
I don't believe you.
Oh, okay. Is that because you're driving?
No.
Yeah.
Rick won't talk to anybody.
Oh, bullshit. You're a fucking liar.
No, no.
You're such a...
I don't know if you're going to say that, Debbie.
Because you're lying.
That's just the way that Rick is. That's the way that Rick is.
That's the way that Rick is.
They don't even talk. Rick's one of the other. Don't even talk.
Oh, yeah? Is that because you're hearing?
He's one of those guys that don't even talk.
Yep, and I'm lying my ass off to you right now, I'm being honest about it.
Oh, my. Okay, so he drops it pretty fast. He knows he's caught pretty quickly. Yeah, I'm lying my ass off, and I'm telling you the truth about it.
How could you keep that lie up, though? You know?
He clearly couldn't. He's like, he wanted to so bad. He really thought he had it. Like, he's like, oh, I'll just say my silent friend Rick. He's mute. He don't talk. Idiots.
Exactly, DJ Payne. That's my mom.
I can't believe
you
got in your car.
I know, Debbie. Okay.
Right, I'm calling the cops right now.
Go ahead. Go ahead, Debbie.
Fucking bitch.
Call the cops on me. Just give me a bad move.
Oh, yeah? What are you going to do?
I'll speed up.
Nothing.
I'll speed up.
You'll speed up?
I'll speed up.
A fucking tree.
Yep.
Drive into a tree, bitch.
By the time I'm home?
Yeah, by the time you're
home. They won't have a clue. By the time I'm home, they won't have a clue.
Okay.
I'll be home and they won't have a clue.
When they get there.
I won't go home. I'll go over to Tony's. Or I'll go to Elton's. Yeah. Or I'll go somewhere in Canaan. Or somewhere in Cambridge.
Uh-huh.
Don't fuck around, Debbie. I care about my mom.
Don't fuck around.
Don't you dare call the police, Debbie. I'll go into hiding, I swear to God. Don't think I won't do it.
I want to make sure
sometimes
my mom's all right.
Like, Tiffany talks, and like my mind gets poured out on these calls, and everything I ever want to say to Lauren, Tiffany says. That's why I think I love her so much.
Yeah, it's pretty cathartic hearing her berate.
That's the only purpose of me going on my mom's house. Debbie,
you're such a liar.
I didn't get you on the phone to cause problems for me, Debbie.
You're causing problems for yourself.
I care about my mom. Do you think I want that around my mom?
No, of course not.
That's what I care about.
Of course not.
I sacrifice my life and get in an accident. I don't care.
You kill someone else?
I care about my mom. I'm not that intoxicated to do that.
Yeah, you know, you think they're going to find you? They're going to think you're sober when they give you a breathalyzer?
Okay, Debbie, you want to be that smart to fucking hold shit against me like that?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
Goodbye.
What are you going to do, you fucking bitch?
Don't hang up. I hung up on her.
Wait. Debbie better fucking step the fuck back.
She's just making a sandwich. It's okay.
Debbie better step the fuck back.
Yeah, well, I'm just trying to protect my mom.
I know. I understand.
From Debbie.
She better dial back
calling me out on my bullshit, you know? She better dial that shit back.
Better knock it off. I'm trying to protect her from my mom from her.
Well, I can't control her, baby. I tried. And she's just making a sandwich.
Hey, Mr. Lord.
What?
If she wants to fucking play tough and bullshit, all this fucking bullshit, I will hire a private investigator and get on her ass.
Just ignore it, baby. She just doesn't want anybody to get hurt, that's all. Oh. She's making a sandwich. I'm looking
at her. I understand that. I do not need her threatening me with shit.
Well, stop telling me, because I can't fix anything. All I'm doing is trying to help you, okay? Stop putting me in the middle.
Okay. I want the recording erased.
I didn't even record. Emma told me how to do it, but it didn't work.
Okay. I want that recording erased.
I want that incredibly incriminating recording erased, baby.
Yeah, baby. Don't incriminate me.
Delete that recording that proves that I violated my probation, baby.
Right. Baby, are you incriminating me right now?
I want all four of us to know that it was erased.
Wow. It didn't even start. It said error.
Mm-hmm. All four of us.
What?
I want all four of us to know that it is erased.
Why?
Because. As much as I love you, I still need to look out for my ass.
Well, just pull over then.
I want all four of us to know that it's erased.
I don't know what you're talking about. What? Let you guys know what's on my phone? How the fuck am I supposed to do that? I'm telling you.
I want you to tell Debbie.
Give a shit about me, then you're not.
I want you to tell Debbie from now on. I want you to tell Debbie from now on. She should never threaten me again.
All right. Lauren said, "Don't threaten him again."
So if she threatens me again, I will take out a loan and get a private investigator on her ass.
Fine.
Whoa.
She wants to play fucking dumbass?
Did you ever hear that voicemail? The I'm coming after you for theft.
Oh,
that one.
I fucking love it. Where he does the Winnie, Xavier.
Right.
You
Dan, Emma.
Dan.
Yeah, a lawsuit. And so I want my letters and my recordings back, or else I'm coming after you for theft.
I was going to say that. Something right. About that earlier. I love that voicemail.
It's so funny.
Fine.
She wants to be nice to me. She wants to be nice to me. I'll be nice to her.
Will you stop now? I'm done hearing about what my sister did. I can't fucking control it. I'm just here for you. Stop it now.
Nice equals kissing his ass and putting up with any of the illegal shit he does.
Precisely.
Let me ask her if she's going to stop.
I'm not going to get her on the fucking phone. She's looking at me all pissed off. Don't start a problem between me and my sister. All she's going to do is yell at you.
I'm not starting a problem.
Right. Hire a private investigator for what? Exactly. What would they be looking for? Find out where she lives for me.
She's making a sandwich. She's getting some milk. And she's going to go watch some Netflix thing with Gigi. Just leave her alone.
What kind of sandwich do you have?
Peanut butter.
Nope.
What is that? And jam.
Peanut butter and what?
And what? Peanut butter and what?
No, I want peanut butter and marshmallow.
Ugh.
We don't have a marshmallow.
No. Peanut butter or what?
I don't want to put you on the spot, but could I please get you to do, like, I think the best Lorne impression you've ever done is the, am I sober? No, but could you please do that, like, in Lorne's voice?
When does he say that? Am I sober? No.
It's in the Nathanielette call with Mike V, where she's talking about she picked him as a role model. And it goes right. Towards her sobriety.
That's funny. Like, he's like
if you could conjure that up. Well, am I sober? No, but.
Well, am I sober? No, but. But. Well, am I sober? No, but.
But.
Peanut and molasses.
Peanut butter and molasses? What? That sounds like a redneck sandwich.
That's what fucking Roy used to eat. I've never had it, but Roy did.
That is what Roy used to eat. That is exactly what Roy used to eat.
As a redneck born and raised myself, right. I can confirm that peanut butter and molasses is a very redneck sandwich.
Good. That's what Roy used to eat. That is precisely what Roy used to eat.
Roy seemed to like it.
What are you doing?
It was gross. Try me a smart ass.
No, what are you physically doing?
I'm physically home.
Because I drove drunk.
What are you going to do with that information?
I just need to know what the fuck you're doing, because you're being weird. God,
that sound, Lauren. And here comes the Beatles again. Nice try. Thought you could get me.
And then you say you
couldn't. Nice fools.
And you never did. Why are you such a liar?
Because I don't care about Roy.
Tears?
I do care about Roy. But I care about Mom more than anybody. He's at Mom's house and he's not supposed to be doing this shit.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay, but there were other options to have this solved, and you completely negated all of them. You didn't even follow a single idea. It was all about getting in my car. Well, why are you apologizing?
Because I know I was wrong. I know I was wrong in doing it.
He sounds like he's being abducted.
That's unfucking believable.
He does, yeah. He's like resisting the pull.
Time and time again, you just keep doing the same shit.
Debbie, come on. Don't lay a bunch of stuff on me right now, please.
I should. You need to hear it.
Rip his ass, please.
Yeah, please don't do it right now.
It's going to be a good time,
please.
According to you. Why? Why right now? When's a good time?
Because right now all I care about is if Mom's hearing Roy.
You should have called your brother.
That's what you care about.
She's right next to him in the bedroom, right fucking next to him.
Oh, no.
Fuck off.
I don't even hear him. He's probably sleeping at this point.
He never sees his mom. So, like, the fact that he even remotely claims to give a fuck about her.
Come on.
You know, it's just infuriating to me.
It's only when he tries to garner sympathy. That's when he loves his mom.
I don't understand, Lauren. I don't understand.
It's okay, baby. Just relax.
Don't cry, Lauren. Nice try again. You know what? I think that's probably the end of the call. Yeah, they got me. These sneaky little songs. Okay. Well, I think I'm going to wrap it up here. I don't really have much else to play, and I'm getting a little tired. So I think I'm gonna end it here. But thanks, everybody, for coming out and hanging out for so long. And thanks to everyone in the Discord for accompanying me. That was a lot of fun. Definitely also do that again soon. And
Thank you for putting up with me. I know everyone comes here for Lorne Identity, but I very much appreciate everyone humoring me a little bit, you know. I know I'm cringy as hell and not very funny, but I do appreciate everybody, you know, even giving me a moment of notice, you know.
Of course. It was a lot of fun. And thank you, Callie, and thank you, guy named Kevin, if you're still in here. Had a lot of fun.
Thank you. This was really fun. All right. Well, I'm getting sleepy too.
I'm gonna play a song to play us out, and I'll see you guys next time. I'm gonna mute the Discord. Bye.
tell you how I feel. I want to drive you through the night, down the hills. I gotta tell you something you don't want to hear. I'm gonna show you where it's dark, but have no fear.
There's something inside you, it's hard to explain. They're talking about you, boy, but you're still the same. There's something inside you, it's hard to explain. They're talking about you, boy, but you're still the same.
I'm giving you a night call to tell you how I feel. I want to drive you through the night, down the hills. I gotta tell you something you don't want to hear. I'm gonna show you where it's dark, but have no fear.
There's something inside you, it's hard to explain. They're talking about you, boy, but you're still the same. There's something inside you, it's hard to explain. They're talking about you, boy.